It's all right. You know, internet and stuff.
There you go. Let's try that again.
What's good, YouTube? It is your boy Thesis, aka Thesis himself, from Vaping with Thesis. That's right. God bless it. Now, look. Bitch. Okay, smother trucking. So, I apologize first and foremost. We had to go rescue Mandy at her job. Her car wouldn't start, even though it was in a heated garage. So, welcome to Minnesota. We were going to be. Apologize for the echo as well. On top of that shit. Let's go and get to the comment section, my ninja kitties. Let's see. Mike Cherokee, what's going on, bro? Hand Josh Hoyt, yo, Matt Steele, ZZ Sleep 12. Hi. Mike Cherokee says, what up, Don Flores, William D. Bollinger, Avalanche, motherfucking reviews, son. Hit that like button, ninja kitties. Studley Steamer, nice to see you in the panel, bro. How's it going? What are you doing tonight, bro? Well, hold on. Before we get to Studley Steamer, let's go talk to Shua. How was life? What are you acting?
Life is good.
What are you rocking for the buffet?
I'm rocking my own.
Speak about this.
This is a custom made dual MOSFET 26650 parallel.
But real quick, explain to everybody why you do the dual MOSFET.
Put it this way. This is a lot of amperage through it.
A lot of amps.
So you're putting a lot of power through one MOSFET. Put two of them on there, it cuts the amp past the
end. It's a lot like wearing double condoms, though.
It's just a little bit safer for something this power. Yeah, with 0.09 coils in it.
That's right. You got the dental dam, birth control, EpiPen, and a condom. You'll be safe. You'll be good to go. You're golden, right? Is that all you're rocking? You got the ProtoVapor?
I got my ProtoVapor and the Hellbeast.
What are you rocking for liquid?
I got Concussion from local Vermilion River.
Sounds terrible. You got a concussion from Vermilion River. He was swimming when he wasn't supposed to be. As simple as that. Guys, real quick, I want to hear what everyone in the chat is rocking. ZZ Sleep says, oh, I was noticed. Cute. Zados, you fucking is. Stormtrooper Rabbit, what's going on, bro? Avalanche says, have y'all tracking numbers? Yeah, posted them on the Patreon page yesterday, bro.
Yeah,
on the lens. On the lens. Not the, I didn't post them. I didn't make a post. I posted on the lens. Look at the morose mofos right here. That's right. J Money, what's going on, bro? Hit that like button, son. So I'm going to go through the quick buffet. I am rocking the dildo mod. This is the third dildo mod that I had picked up. Shout out to nobody because essentially this is still acting weird. I don't give a fucking, even if this one only lasts 3 months, that's a happy camper. $50, not bad. Rocking the drag fucking mini, the lipo one. This is from Mighty Rose. Thank you so much, Mighty Rose. As well as I'm rocking the Jenna with the 510 modification. I'll show you guys on camera that Jay was not happy I did, but I'll tell you what, I fucking love the shit out of this RDA with the 510. Huge shout out to my boy Jay for actually sending this bad bitch out.
It may be an 810, but it's not bad with the 510.
It's not. It's just a preference thing. I like that laser sight of flavor. Decent. Yeah. I'll give you that. And then on top of that, I'm rocking on the bottom of that is the top side dual squawk. Fucking phenomenal mod. Not as comfortable as I'd want it to be.
It's a little wide. It's a little hefty.
It's actually, I like good. The heftiness of it. I do. The thing is, I would compare it to something like the. Oh my God. Dean's fucking squawk.
Basium.
The Basium. Compare it to like the Basium.
Yeah, actually, that's not the bad comparison.
They're both about the same weight. They're both really hefty. The difference is just in shape, the ergonomics of it. Josh White, were you listening to self titled earlier? Now, I was, as a matter of fact. Holy fuck. How did you know that? No, but for real, how did he know that?
Because he probably
I was a self-titled too. and Apathy. Yeah. Stormtrooper says, I'm rocking the Rage with Hadley on top of the Wizmec Relu Dual 2700 with Gear RTA. It's a solid setup. What's up, Shane? And then we got Black China. Nothing. You're out of juice? Well, I just sent off your package.
Yeah.
And there's no juice in it. What the fuck?
No.
Black China?
It's okay. You sent mine?
Yeah. Okay. And mine. Oh, no, you got juice coming. I put juice in there. You're golden, ho. Anthony you, Velasco, Rob. What's going on, Broham? Now, let's go ahead and get to Stan. Sully Steamer, what are you vaping on, dog? And he's muted.
Hello.
How's it going, bro? What you vaping on?
I am vaping on Cyclops Vapor Phoenix Fresh Crisp Strawberry on the Aegis with raised coils.
That a fucking boy. Yeah, with those raised, you know what's really sad? You had the raid calls before I did, so.
Yeah, I know. He sent me and Josh.
No, I know. I'm very well aware.
Hey, you just be happy, all right? Yours is in that little baggie over there.
You just be happy. You got your hand out today. That's what happened. Matt Steele, Geek Vape Nova with the Fire Luke mesh. Fuck yeah. The Fire Look Mesh Pro is a pretty phenomenal take, except for I would never use it because of the slide mechanism. Let's see.
Jay, I hate what it is, the slide mechanism.
Couldn't agree more.
I have a leak in my car.
Yes. Jay Money.
Look, that's the only reason why I really don't. I really like this fucking Hellbeast tank.
I need to get one.
Let me get to this comment section quick first. Geek Vape Noble with the Fire Look Mesh, G Class with the Reloaded S. J Money. I haven't used the Reload.
No,
not at all. Love that. Yes, the whole Jedi Mind Tricks crew. Josh Hoyt, we gotta talk hip hop one of these days, bro.
What up, Bob Squad?
Avalanche. Was Bob Squad? Bob Squad. That's how life works. Anthony Velasco, what you vaping on, bro? I'm curious.
No, I really like this tank, but I would love it more. It would be perfect if the slide actually locked.
Agreed.
But other than that,
the hell.
That's why I've been keeping with it, because it's fucking good. But
I've heard the Hell Beast is amazing. I want one.
Oh, it's great. I wish that the tank would lock. But that's just me.
I was gonna say, well, not just you. It's me as well. It's exactly what I said.
Well, I mean, some people really like it, but
no, there's nobody who likes it.
I need a tank that's got an RBA section, so that way I can use raised coils.
Studley, I love you more than life itself. Speak in the softest tone you possibly can.
Sorry.
Poor, no, don't be sorry. No, it's not your fault. You don't have any headphones to have feedback. It's my fault. Like everything, it's all good. PH Vapor says the Reload S is the new one, mate. Single coil banger. You know. I'm slowly but surely enjoying the single coil life, and it's rare that happens. All right, Stan, you got to meet your shit, Doug.
Okay.
I love you.
I take yours.
And that's no PS. Anyone watching, that's no offense to Sully Seamer. I love Sully Seamer, but when he has his phone, his other phone go off, the shit hurts my earbuds. Vapor Range has him for like $20 free shipping. No shit. Smok TF V8, the RBA deck. No shit on the TF V8.
The one that I got from you had the RBTA.
That's a RBA fucking phenomenal tank. That was when Smok.
That thing was kind of entertaining, actually. It was nice to be able to just play with it. And if you didn't have any coils, you're like, oh, fuck, I'll just use my own. I appreciate that, at least.
The rebuildable deck of the Freemex, Fire Luke. It, which is so weird to say this. It's the same model, but it depends on what time period you got it at. The metal on the earlier ones were thicker. The metal on the actual chimney itself were thicker. Okay. So it would retain heat longer, which is the downside. But the positive part is it wouldn't get your liquid as hot as quick as the thin metal. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't relying on the liquid to keep it cool. And then on top of that, you had it was a millimeter or two difference with the build deck. So you have a better build deck on the newer Freemax Firelocks with thinner metal. If they would just swap the tops, which is what I did for Sudley Steamer.
Nice.
Yeah, I swapped the tops, and it was a better version. I wish I would have did that to begin with. No. Candace says, okay.
I'm curious on yours. David Van Diver.
Van Diver.
Suggestions on an intermediate level for a trucker. I guess my first thing would be, what's your price range?
Always first question. But if you're a trucker, the same thing that I recommended for Bob, I talked about last week, who's got these two beautiful proto vapors that just going to waste, is... Sounds if you're a trucker, you want two things, in my opinion. You want battery life, only because I would think that I wouldn't want to be plugged into my 12 volt all day. Shane says, I discovered. Oh, let me finish this thought though. If you're someone who smokes cigarettes heavily, and if you're someone that needs a throw hit, like you smoke, say, Marlboros, Matt Oswald, how's it going? I would go into something like a Nick Salt, like a pod system, in my opinion. Mm-hmm. My favorite pod system right now is the Inikin DV, as well as the Pavina Puro. If you want something with a shit ton of liquid that's cheap, bro, you cannot go wrong with the vapor, with the Hellbeast, because they have the bigger tanks, the bubble glass form now. Yeah. And you can't go wrong with a Freemax mesh, because you're not, it's not gonna be in your pocket. You're in the truck, the mesh pro. I mean, the mesh pro, it's a solid setup. And then in terms of a mod, I mean, fuck. I would go with a lipo because it's
yeah, lipo could be easier.
Yeah, because you don't have to worry about using.
You don't have to worry about swapping out your batteries. Plus, you can just charge them right there in the truck if need be.
Yep. Cletus Shrank, what's going on? Joshua, sexy deer.
Taking off, guys. I'm feeling like shit. Just dropped in to say hey. Well, hello, Avalanche. Good to see you.
Love you, bros. Thank you so much for joining, Avalanche. Hey, Kelt. Hope you feel better, by the way. Smok Nord. I've got a shit ton of those behind me, man. I've been rocking. That Smok Nord is just not dope, in my opinion, at all. I'm not a fan. Although, if you like loose MTLs, it's a great pod. I'm just not a fan of. I like my MTLs to be a strict MTL. Again, just my preference. Hit that like button, guys, if you haven't done so. Let's see. Shin Smith says, hey, Sin, where's Sin? Oh, Sin N with the hearts. Texas Young Gun, about to get my Lizard Komodo Squonker. Have you? I have not used. Matter of fact, I don't even heard of it. What
the fuck is Komodo?
Yeah, Lizard?
The Lizard Komodo?
Komodo? Komodo Squonk. How come I haven't heard of this? Single battery Squonker, DNA 75. Hmm. So she's going to be more on the spendy side, isn't she? I'm going to Jay Hayes's. Yeah, 315. $350. I got the Jenna right here, and ouch. I can tell you guys right now, high-end life is great. Like, I love all my high-end mods, but at the same time, at the end of the day, I'm rocking a drag and a topside, granted, with the Jenna. But, like, my beater is my Proto Vapor Silo. $200-some bucks, but it's mm-hmm. I beat the piss out of it. Oh, it's
fucking worth it.
Yeah, it's worth every fucking penny.
Mine was 220.
Yeah.
Something like that, roughly. And this thing is still just kicking away. Yep. So.
Sin, give you hearts. Matt Oswald said, I will get a soon Fury Squonker and a Legend RDTA from E Phoenix. The Legend RDTA is solid, but the Fury Squonker, again, same as I don't get that many squonks in sent in.
Yes, Josh Hoyt. Both of them do have Pro Vapor. You can select either with or without a belt clip.
Iron Vapes, Carol V. No, the invite is through YouTube. It's on Patreon page, Carol. Just go to the Patreon app. And literally just visit it, check out my most recent post, and you can join. If you guys are on the Patreon page, you are able to join the panel. Yep. You click on that bitch and you can follow.
Unless you were referring to just the invite to the
Sunny Ibarra. What's going on? Catherine Adams, I'll clap and wave to you. Cute. Who else is here? I just heard somebody join. Kristen!
Quit the mode.
Hi.
What up, girl?
Not much. Just watching Farscape.
Did you get you watch what?
Farscape.
Horsecape.
You guys ever watch Farscape? It's from 1999 from Sci-Fi. I've
never even heard of it.
Made by Jim Henson, Brian Henson.
I know Jim Henson. I don't know who Brian
Henson. Yeah, Brian Henson. All puppets and everything. It's great. You gotta look it up. It's awesome.
I'll check it out. Is it is it spooky?
It's sci-fi. It's aliens. It's
kind of sounds sort of familiar.
As soon as you guys see it, you will know what it is. It's awesome.
Thank you, Carol, for doing that. Huge shout to Carol. She offered a purge mod earlier today. I was talking to Josh. That's an amazing thing. That's but at the same time, I feel guilty for if I were to even say yes. Like, I just feel bad about it. Bob Squatch says Farscape. I guess I'm just not into sci-fi. Totally. I've never seen Star Wars or Star Trek or anything like that.
I think I tried watching like one episode and it was okay. I do remember Natane watching it though.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Manny's in like dumb vampire shit.
It's a little drama-y for me, but whatever. Still, yeah, now that I see the picture, yeah, it does look kind of familiar.
Mm-hmm. It's hilarious. It's awesome. It's not like Star Trek or Star Wars or any of that.
I like anything. It's
more drama filled than, it's more drama filled, but it's about as sci-fi as
Game of Thrones.
No, Serenity.
Firefly. Yeah.
I fucking loved me some Firefly.
I used to be obsessed.
It's not on Netflix anymore, which kind of pisses me off because that was fun just to rewatch.
Yeah. I used to be obsessed with Buffy only because, like, a full disclosure, would like jerk off to whatever her, I forget her name.
No way.
Michelle Geller?
Michelle, yeah. But then I realized that Sabrina the teenage witch had a nicer ass, so then I switched. It's that simple. I'm going to go ahead and vape with Kent. I'm going to go ahead and email Vape with Kent, see if he wants to join, guys. Shit.
Josh Hoyt, do not say very much because I'm still working on season 2. Oh. I do love me that fucking
show. I haven't started that series.
Punisher?
I didn't like the movie. I never read the comics or anything.
The movie, like the old movie, yeah, it was a little rough. But right now, it's the actual series on Netflix is pretty fucking good.
Adam Breezy Tones, how's it going, love? Be right back, guys.
It's about as good quality as like an actual movie, but it's a TV series.
Yeah, like it's still the guy that was Shane in Walking Dead, right? I forget his name. Yeah.
I fucking hated Shane from Walking Dead, right?
I did too. I hated him. He was a scum, but the point is, he's a good actor, and he plays a damn good Punisher.
That's what I was getting at. So the reason why I found out that I loved him was because of how much I hated him and then how much I liked him in real life.
Mm-hmm.
If you listen to the podcast, I don't remember which episode it was. It would have been like in the 600s of Joey Diaz, Church of What's Happening Now with, I forget his name. No, it's not 600s. That was, that would have been... Oh, regardless, if you listen to that actor with Joey Diaz on Church, bro, like it is, me and him could have been BFFs growing up.
Yeah.
BFF, dude was facing prison time, all sorts of shit. And I put myself in his position of why he did it. Now I would do that shit twice. Someone tried to fucking steal his dog in front of him. And then fucking, bro, listen, I love my kids. I love my animals.
Someone tried to steal his dog in front of him.
Yeah, full blown. Yep. You have to listen to the story.
Man, you got a nice dog. Yeah, thanks. He's mine now.
No. Like the dude called him over when he was inside of a kiosk or like a malt shop. Let's just say that, probably getting meth.
But I'm sure I'm being more humorous about it. But still, that's really weird.
Would you murder somebody over your dog?
I don't have a dog.
If you had a dog, would you murder somebody over?
This dog is a complete dick, and if I don't have him, he's gonna bite the shit out of someone else, and then they're gonna realize he's a complete dick. I wouldn't murder anyone over a dog.
I would,
but I would definitely stop them from taking the dog.
That's what I'm trying to say. Like,
but you don't need to murder them
when there's 9 dudes and it's just you.
Okay, so what are you gonna do?
Well, I always carry a pistol, so.
Well, see, that's you.
Right.
But now you're asking me.
So if someone tried to steal my dog, it's like stealing my child.
Then you take the process and you're like, okay, that guy's trying to steal my dog. Everyone has a fucking smartphone nowadays. Click, click. You don't need to be like, oh, bang, bang.
Well, I wouldn't.
I only got 8 bullets, so you're going to have to get in.
You don't ever start right shooting. That's not a good idea. There's a whole process you have to go through. Plus, that's why I also carry insurance. First off,
how many enemies do you think I have?
No, that's the whole point. Is if you were to listen to the fucking story, Shua, you would know that this was a random thing.
Where's again being funny about it? I'm a stand-up comedian.
Grab
sorry, I couldn't help it.
Christy, let me ask you a question.
Oh God, what?
So let me preface this by saying Josh and I we're both comedy snobs. Like I am addicted to every podcast you can imagine that has to do with my favorite comedians. Joey Diaz, Bert Kreischer is my spirit animal. Rogan, of course. I listen to 100%, meaning from front to back, 3 hours, 4 hours, doesn't matter. Of every episode, even when I'm sleeping, of all my favorite of Your Mom's House, of fucking Pete Holmes, all these fucking podcasts. So I'm just prefacing that. So Josh and I love comedy. What does the word stand-up comedian mean to you, Christy?
Stand-up comedian? I don't know. I mean, I just can... The only thing I really... think of when I hear stand-up comedian is all the old ones that, you know, I grew up with. I can only think of people. I really don't think of anything else other than people.
We'll change it. We'll say,
just the definition.
Is someone who sits on camera and makes a joke a stand-up comedian, or is someone who actually goes on stage and performs a stand-up comedian?
No, performer. Definitely performer.
Thank you. Okay, agreed. 100%. Okay, because you cannot... I'm this isn't any braggadocious, I won't even drop names, but I'm friends with a small handful of real comedians, headlining, touring comedians. And one of them, Josh actually met him, one of them was super nice. He's like, bro, like especially if you watch your older videos, like your rants and shit, like you could do stand-up. He's like, you were going to suck in the beginning like everyone else, of course. It takes years to hone that fucking talent. And even then, you're still going to bomb because you're working on new material. Mm-hmm. He said,
"You also have to read the room."
He's like, "You're an online."
It's a difficult thing,
right? He's like, "You're an online comedian," and that was a huge compliment because I wouldn't even consider that. But if I were to go back and call him up, like, "Bro, I'm a stand-up comedian," because I film myself, that is not a stand-up. That's not stand-up comedy. I'm kind of curious on what the comments actually thinks.
What up, Big Doc?
What's up, E-Sigas? Big Doc. Oh fuck! I wonder, am I the only person that ever wonders? Like, he's 9 foot tall, right? Is his dick coincide with?
Are you wondering if he's anatomically incorrect?
Proportionately,
across the board.
Now, that you say something, I'm thinking about it, but I don't think about
it. It's not on my day to day, kind of normal.
Let me just give you an example. So, in high school, I can't remember his name on the internet. I can mention the other kid's name because no one knew it. He was super mong, and we just call him Mitsu because he drove a Mitsubishi. Super racist. Now that I'm thinking about it, but. Because in West St. Paul, like, there's a lot, it's all Mexicans, all Hmong, and like, and a few black people, you know, just sprinkled upon, like, just like paprika, just like not a lot, just enough. But this one kid, we'll call him T. He was, this dude was like dark chocolate, like 75% cocoa, and he, I don't want to say which college he got a scholarship to and went on to be an NBA player. He's a fucking great basketball player now. But at the time, he was just he was cool. Me and him were good friends. We were just funny. We would giggle, we'd poke. You know what I'm saying? And it was a funny pair because we'd go and eat lunch together. This dude is 6'7". I mean, we're in ninth fucking grade. Mind you, I peaked in high school in terms of height. I'm 5'10", 3/4". Fuck you, Josh. I'm going to still say 3/4". 5'10", 3/4", and this dude's 6'7". When I say black, like, I mean, like, almost blue. You know what I'm saying? He's his name is, like, he's from Savannah. How could it be? Now, listen, when I say
black, blue, whatever, continue.
You don't know what I'm talking about? You're looking me in the face and say you don't know what I'm talking about.
I don't know what you're talking about. Continue with the story.
Anyway, because you got
I've heard the story. From the African continent.
Yes,
like that.
He was second. Black? He would have been. His parents were from.
Moving on.
The motherland. He's not, but he still had the name, the last name. I'm Mexican and native. I'm super light skinned, right? Like, I'm and I get made fun of it all the time with my family, which is adorable. Stop making fun of me. Not that light skinned. So listen. Long story short, we were at gym, and there's only three or four of us that showered because, I don't know, we're fucking human and don't want to smell like assholes trying to pull bitches in ninth grade. You know what I'm saying? We had these pillar showers. There was no privacy. It was just a fucking pillar with four shower heads. Long story short is...
So you have to look at everybody else? I have to
look at everybody else. Now, I'm not saying I'm porn star status. I'm not saying I'm Asian status. I'm just saying. I'm happy. I'm a happy ass camper. Now, Trevor. Oh, god damn it!
You said it.
No, I didn't. No, because that's not his real name.
Tanabuni. Continue.
Spins around.
Trevanana.
No, that's okay because that's not his real name. It's all right. That's not his real name. what?
Sorry. Continue.
Spins around.
We'll get to that.
And you expect this 6'7" like. Fresh off the boat, African dude to just be packing. And it wasn't packing. Not at all. Mitsu, on the other hand, Hmong kid, Mitsubishi, his height peaked in like sixth grade, 5'6" and shit. Turns around with a baby's arm holding an apple. And that is and that right there is where I felt like I should stop believing in stereotypes.
Yeah, I don't believe in stereotypes whatsoever.
So when I ask Big Doc, I wonder if he's got big cock.
Well, we have asked him, and he has responded with, "Think about a Morton salt can. Not much length, but lots of girth."
Jesus Christ, a Morton salt can?
That's not why I was laughing, by the way.
That's like double fist wanding.
I was laughing Stormtrooper Rabbit. Josh looks more Mexican than you, Thesis.
Thanks, that's fucked up, I say.
Wait, thanks.
Hijo de la chingada. Mira, Joshua.
See?
Hurts my feelings. except for you can see his pinkness. Look at, because you can see the pinkness. Mine just comes off as this like paper sack yellow, which pisses me off. If the worst part is like, if you see my grandparents, so like you can see the lineage.
Yeah.
Half my family is Indio, Mexican Indian, like Native American before there was a fucking border. And then the other half is like tall, light-skinned Mexican from Mexico, and you can see where that lineage kind of came together, and I'm like that weird mixture in between. You know, like, you don't, okay. Like, you know, Louis C.K., like, he's Mexican, he's red-haired six foot one, whatever he is, and doesn't look like it. That's half of my family looks like that.
Dude, so I'm Alaska Native, right? And like I'm as dark as my whole entire family gets. We're Alaska Native, but this is as dark as I get. American and Alaska Native. There is an island just off of where I was born called Metlakatla. There is a whole, like, few, five, six families that live over there that are full-blooded Native, Tlingit, Haida, that all have bright red hair. Brown skin, bright red hair.
Right. That's not that uncommon.
It's all because back in the day, I can't remember exactly when, but there was this priest called Father Duncan. He had red hair. And when all of the fishermen were out fishing and everything, he raped and slept with all their wives. So his red hair is everywhere on that mm-hmm. island. Brown skin, bright red hair.
I'll repeat. Louis C.K.
I can't say shit. I'm German and Swiss and Austrian.
So you're a Nazi socialist? This makes no sense.
I'm everything else uncool from Europe. Like everything that you just don't ever want to be.
Just
because I'm German does not mean I'm a Nazi. We're going to cover that right now.
I know, because your other half is Swiss. Swiss is full-blown socialist and beautiful. I get it. You're a perfect
immigrant. No,
the
Swiss are the, quote, nice Germans.
we'll take you into our country,
there's
but
a
we
level,
won't kill you.
There's a level as you're going through Switzerland where it's like, you have a very kind of French sound. Well, yeah, they speak more French, more towards the west side. As you're progressing east, it becomes a little more German dialect. And then in far east, it becomes like strong German.
Let me just go ahead and say, come on. So my nephew, aka my little brother, Kyle G, just joined the chat. That is something a rarity.
Hello, Kyle G.
Hit that like button, motherfucker. He's making flower plots and shit. Let's see. Texas Young Gun says, I am Irish white trash Texan. Hey, that's a thing. I've met white trash Texans that are not white and don't speak English, and they're just as white trash Mexican Texan as everybody else. I call those Texarkanans. Because right on that border of Texarkana, Texas, Arkansas, and Kansas. Bam. That's why I consider myself red Mexican. I want to lift the trucks, Mexican flag, some chickens, a chicken named like Flaco and like Budweiser. You know what I'm saying? Put all those together. Christy, so what is it like where you live? Where do you live again? Isn't it Washington? That's what I've thought. Specifically, what is it like? Does everyone have stretched ears and is like Nirvana fans?
If you're like actually in Seattle, like it's only around Seattle area where people, they're hipsters, straight up hipsters, like man bun.
Trust me, that's not beard, just around Seattle. Long
mustache, and then all the girls have like the biggest glasses they can get, the short hair with the hats that you can't even see their short hair. That's only in Seattle. Other than that, all other places in Washington, I mean, they're just like anybody else, I guess. But Seattle's weird.
But Seattle seems strange. Yeah. Real quick, I want to say, Sin N says, I'm Irish, so pale, I'm almost see-through. I like to call that fluorescent or neon.
That's what my sister is. My sister is, you know, Alaska Native too, but she's see-through. She's literally see-through.
It's called fluorescent. I call those
fluorescent
rituals, which fluorescent lives matter.
That's not all right. We're gonna move on.
So hold on, real quick. So I was really good friends with this.
I'm see through. It doesn't really make you fluorescent.
It sure does. No. So you turn the lights off and you can still see the silhouette for a couple of minutes. Yeah, that's pretty much fluorescent.
No. Yeah, she's not that white. Like she's see through. It's more see through.
Texas Young Gun just said my Mexican brother had a child with a Canadian. We call him Kinexican. That's fucking awesome. That's badass.
That's nice.
So the reason why I ask is are you a Nirvana fan?
Me?
Yeah.
I like them, fuck. But they're so overplayed. Metallica, Nirvana, and AC/DC, I can't listen to anymore because they've been overplayed too much.
I can understand that,
and I will appreciate. And as well, you don't like Nirvana? Good girl.
Well, I like Nirvana. The biggest reason being, so the studio that they recorded I call it the Utero album, but it's the Utero type shit. What the fuck is the album called? The one with the baby?
Oh, I have no idea.
That was recorded literally right there from my house. Like, see my finger? Right there. And if you look at the lost home montage tapes of Nirvana, you can legitimately see my neighbor's home, which is fucking like, so I didn't realize this. So when I was
could have been on early Nirvana, you could have got into the music game so early.
Right. So I was like, oh, I was barely born, man. I was in that shit. Motherfucker. So if you look at it, and this is a true story, this is true shit. When I first got into music, one of the things that blew my mind was my dad. And when you're a kid, you don't fucking think about it. My dad's like, bro, like, you don't get where you live. Like, there's a house right over there that Michael Jackson, Janet Jackson, Prince, all these artists fly from wherever they're at to come right here, this place you fucking hate. And when I was a kid, I didn't like it. And I moved back and then realized, oh, nope, moving back to the place I thought I didn't like because I love it. But they would fly to come out in the middle of nowhere. In Cannon Falls, Minnesota. That's not where I lived, but like it was right there.
Yeah.
And from my rooftop, my literal actual roof of the house, I could see the plot of land that studio set. It looks like a regular house. Like it looks like it looks like a giant, you know, not a mansion, but a giant regular house. Come to find out, Pachyderm Studios is one of the most sought after studios in the nation because it's in the middle of nowhere in the woods.
It's a lot of rock artists did that. They literally went out into the middle of the woods and
Static X.
They couldn't focus otherwise. They'd be around too many people.
Well, if you watch the home footage of Nirvana here at that studio, it didn't look like they focused much anyway. Regardless,
probably.
I need my quiet so I can focus so I can make a song that I can play on stage. And
meanwhile, they're jumping off decks into an indoor pool. So I'm like, all right. Plus, his murderer was on film talking to him. So, like, it's bizarre.
So bizarre.
Specifically because Courtney Love shot his ass.
Let's go ahead. The only place in Seattle that possibly my guys know of, you know the movie Up? The kids movie Up?
Yep.
So, that house that he has, it's an actual house here in Seattle that won't get torn down because the lady, I guess, wouldn't sell it. And it's right next to like Ross and Trader Joe's.
Was that movie actually based on that house?
It was based. I wasn't grown up here. This is what I've heard. It was based on the house. It's exactly the exact same house. It is the exact same house.
Because that'd be my only curiosity.
They raised enough money and they bought the land and they won't tear it down now because the movie, the lady, she would not sell the land at all, even though there's all these department stores all around it. There's just this one little square where that house from Up is sitting there. I don't know the whole story, but that house is, that's the Up house.
That's, first of all, that's badass. That's because all ideas spawn from something, right? Yeah. I mean, this doesn't come out of nowhere.
That was just that'd be my one curiosity. Yeah. If the house was based, like they looked at the house and they're like, we can make a movie just from this idea. Cool.
Yeah, it was the idea. It was something about the ladies. She didn't have any kids. She lived there with her husband, and her husband died, but she wouldn't sell the location at all. She just would not. And it was tore down. It was, people kept going in there. The homeless kept going in there and sleeping in there until finally somebody just bought the land and just fixed it up, put a gate around it, and that's what it is. It's the Up house now.
That's crazy. Just,
like, so it's that level of cheesiness where it's like, oh, I really like this movie, so I made my house that. That's kind of annoying, but as long as it was like prior, all right, that's kind of cool.
Definitely prior.
So if you guys take a quick peek, what the am I 63 years old, Josh? If you guys go on YouTube, just type in Nirvana Pachyderm Studios, you'll find a channel called Rare Nirvana. 31,000 subscribers, but it's right here, Cannon Falls, Minnesota. It's literally from my house, for where me and Josh are sitting. It's a 3-minute drive to this studio. I'm about to pull it up and play it if you guys want to play it. But at the same time, for those of you following,
what's it online, called?
Pachyderm, Pachyderm, like the animal, Pachyderm Studio.
And where can you find it on YouTube?
Just type in Nirvana Pachyderm Studios,
mm-hmm.
and. and it'll all come up. Yeah, right here. So this walkthroughs is 93, and it's kind of creepy when you watch it and you hear "Oh, girl" talking in the background. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. The walkthrough, and it's kind of bizarre, like, because it came back many, many, many times after this. Let's see. I'm gonna go ahead and just play. Yeah, the location right now we're watching, it's showing it's all woods and shit. It's literally right by Cannon River and shit. It's fucking a lot of acreage. And from the rooftop of my house, you could see the plot because it's cut out.
Yeah.
And you could see the tip top, and you couldn't physically see the house and shit. It's pretty secluded. Again, Janet Jackson, Michael Jackson, Static X, Nirvana. Look at the house. That's what I'm talking about right there.
Yeah.
And it looks like a house, but it's not.
Side note, Tex, it's just so funny.
What did he say?
Said the lions on Lion King were based off the lions.
This is true shit. This is true shit. That's being completely stole right now.
Well played, sir. I won. Oh, well, just because I'm curious and because I bought it already. He was wondering how good was Bohemian Rhapsody. Do you mean the album or the movie?
Let's say
because I'm
the curious. Movie. I liked it.
I haven't watched it.
Did you watch it?
Oh, dude. You haven't seen it yet?
It's got feelings in it. I won't watch
it's
it.
It's fucking brilliant. It is not a Queen movie. It is not the movie about Queen. It is the movie about Freddie Mercury.
Yeah.
It's fucking perfect.
How crazy to see someone like Dave Grohl right here 3 miles from this house. Is that crazy? I guess to me it's nuts because I'm obsessed.
Holy shit. Is that a Game Boy?
Oh my God, it is. That might be more interesting than Dave Grohl here.
I don't know. I live in Washington, so I know a lot of people that have met Dave Grohl. But that's why it's so exciting to me because
Minnesota's known for hip-hop, right? Like, Minnesota's known for independent hip-hop rhymesayers. It's not known for grunge. It's not known for... So when you have one of the biggest bands of all time, specifically in the grunge era, 90s... miles from my house, and I found out about it later on. It's crazy to me. It's crazy.
What up, LabWorks?
LabWorks, how's it going, Doc? How come you're not joining this live?
Even Stan's like, get in the live.
Kyle,
we'll take that back. You don't need to join. That's fine.
So Ray Lopez is finally Ray Renalo, que pasó de wey? Hijo de la chingada.
How is Disneyland, huh?
How's Disneyland? Do they have Nazis like in Germany?
That ice cream cone looked amazing.
All right, we're getting. Wait, what are you doing?
We're in the fucking.
Where on this channel? And he's muted. Sorry. I love you, Ray, more than life.
Sorry, Ray. Your picture is very cut out.
It's very Android. And you look like you're in Android land.
Man, I'm gonna blame it on Disneyland.
I'll blame it. Hashtag you nasty. How's it going, bro?
I've been on mine. He has the same phone as I do. So I've been on mine on Hangouts, and it works just fine. So I'm going to blame it on Hangouts.
Danny
blame
Boy
it on
from
Disney
House of Pain bought the house for the movie The Outsiders. No fucking way. Seriously? Which is funny because House of Pain is, to me, like, I don't know nothing about it except for I'm a huge fan of Everlast. Is he at Walmart? He's at Disneyland, which is basically like Walmart in terms of theme parks, I guess. Avalanche, I thought you were going to bed, bro.
I'm roughing it, man. Got to join the live.
Yeah. Got to roughing it in a nice warm house. Come over here, Minnesota, go outside. Then you can rough
roughing it. Cocksuckers.
Roughing it, cocksuckers. All right, I want you to take over the live for about 40, 50 minutes. I'll be right back. Seconds.
Go deuce?
No.
For 40 or 50 minutes, you never know.
Seconds-ish.
I know this is special to you guys in Minnesota, but we just had the most snow that we've had in 10 years in the last 2 days.
How much you guys get?
Washington. 12 inches.
Not bad, though.
At least in Seattle.
Compared to very little? Yeah. Yeah, it's a lot.
Yeah. It's the most snow I've seen in Washington so far. It's the most snow I've seen. I don't even know.
Monday and Tuesday, we're supposed to be getting another like 9 inches on top of the 10 we already have.
Yeah.
Really?
Well, the last storm that just came through was light. I mean, big snowflakes, not heavy and wet, but it got, obviously it still piles up pretty quickly, but.
And we've had 500 accidents somehow.
Yeah. Well, it's because people immediately, it's a snowflake. Ah! And they completely fucking forget how to drive.
Yeah. Heck, I drive. The drivers. I'm fine. And you've seen my car. My car is a piece of crap and extremely light.
Fuck, dude. I drive a fucking Mazda 3. Mine ain't all that much heavier. So.
See, I grew up in Anchorage, so I'm used to the snow, and I've only ever owned trucks. So, like, I'm used to it, but I've heard from everybody, Washington has the worst drivers in the world, and it really showed this last 2 days. It really did.
No, Oklahoma's the worst.
Oklahoma's?
Yeah.
I've never heard that one. I've heard California, and I've heard Washington.
That's not one that I've ever heard either. Oklahoma.
Trust me, I lived there for 7 years. Nobody.
It's a flyover state. How much traffic do they have?
I guess it depends on the stats. I mean, yeah, we had a lot of accidents. But, I mean, do tractors count? Or? Couldn't help it.
Good point.
Anyway.
Oh God!
I obviously, yes, we live in Minnesota, and yes, we know that people fucking suck. As soon as you go outside of major cities, and yes, more people have trucks, more people have availability to drive in that kind of shit. But as soon as you're into a major city, was it last year that we had a decent amount of snow that came down, and I think it was within like the first hour there was over 1,000 accidents.
Yep, it was last year. It took me almost two and a half hours one day to get from Cottage Grove to where the Ford Ranger plant used to be.
Yeah, it was at the time I was in St. Louis Park. So to get from St. Louis Park to the north part of Apple Valley was about 2.5 hours. Normally that's like a 20-minute drive.
Well, you know where, St. Paul Park is, right? In Newport. It took me almost an hour to get from Cottage Grove to the Newport exit. That's a 10-minute drive.
Just yesterday, I think it was yesterday, it took my mother-in-law 2.5 hours just to get from Seattle down here to Kent.
Jesus. Everybody loves snow. Yeah. Wow, that was a quick shit.
I'd have to shit.
Good push.
Oh, this is my.
He used the pinky trick. Now.
Yes, I'm wearing my underwear outside my pants.
The pinky trick.
What?
He rim jobbed his butthole before he took his shit.
You got to get the pinky in there and pull, you know, so it kind of makes like a. It doesn't vapor lock it in there. You got to like keep the pressure.
If you don't, listen, hashtag McNasty drove all the way to California, Kansas.
Hey, it works with babies. It'll work with adults.
That's right. What are you talking about, you gross ass?
Don't worry about it.
I'm saying you use that pinky trick so you can take your shit faster.
Truth.
Same.
Yeah. Snow is snow. You either love it or you hate it.
I love snow.
You either love it
California
or you get
snow.
I like snow on snowmobiles.
Well, me too. For Minnesota, the common answer is you either love snow or you get the fuck out of Minnesota.
Yeah, that's right.
So.
You love negative 36 or you just die. It's one or the other. Tell them, Doc.
It's true.
Christy.
Yes.
You're a beautiful one. Let me ask you a question. Your take, your opinion. Would you go as far as to say you would believe that being a male, quote unquote, vape model or influencer via Instagram is easier or harder than being a woman?
Probably harder. Nobody really wants to see men as models unless they have about 8-pack abs.
Exactly. Thank you.
I'm going to say something, and it's non-sexist, but when it comes to vape models, it comes down to if a woman knows how to do her makeup right, and if she can show off her ass or titties in a picture or a video clip.
Done.
She's a model.
Hashtag non-sexist.
I will be the first one to say it, that we're not downing on anyone who is female who does that.
No, get your cash, boo-boo.
I'm just saying, like,
you can do it.
I'm not saying it's easy for anyone, no matter what you're doing.
but in comparison,
if you've got implants in your ass, if the scale is this
big, you're both down here. Don't get me wrong, but one side is a little higher.
Yeah, because it's a difficult. It's
all right. Well, we'll put it this way: vape and fagging. No offense. Would you rather see vape and fagging or a girl?
Exactly. That's exactly what I was thinking. Like, how many girl reviewers are there out there right now?
And not to burn on him in any way. It just to put it in a comparison.
The reason why I even ask has nothing to do with looks. So. I know a female reviewer from back in the day who quit. Excuse me, because her channel had literally like she was getting zero subscribership and and how do you say that? Views. She was gorgeous. Specifically refused.
It's an information channel.
No. Specifically because
she didn't want to show.
She didn't show her titties off. Didn't show her ass off. Didn't have her nails done. Didn't have her hair done. She wore like minimal makeup.
It's almost more expected that as a woman reviewer or influencer that's what you should be doing as well.
Right. So there's a other side of this where the proof of non-sexism is it's sad because she was just as good, just as in depth as any other male reviewer in existence, but didn't play the part of that hot female.
Yeah.
It's harder for girls in that way. They have to look good. They have to look like models, basically, for people to want to listen to them talk about vape gear because it's vape gear. It's more of a guy industry. And
females, other females, the females that do look like those models are the ones who actually make it more difficult for regular females who don't want to have to put on a whole persona. They're the ones that make it, and they're the ones the first ones scream feminism or sexism, yet they're completely playing into it. Not all of them. I don't know a bunch of them personally, but I'm not even talking about vaping now. If you just look at any tech reviews, it's completely dominated.
Yeah.
It's also because men, generally speaking, tend to be more scientifically based, tend to be more competitive in that aspect.
Techie.
What's that?
More techie.
More techie, which is, okay. I mean, it's not just anecdotal experience. I mean, there's full-blown science based on that, but
yes.
Yeah.
Again, tends to be, not that it always is, but yes.
And I can't believe they have to fucking say that and qualify. Of course, no one fucking.
Yes, Ray, he did get his coils.
I think everywhere thinks the drivers are worse. However, I think drivers from New England State are the best driver only population. Whether I tend to agree. If you go to Minnesota, like the only time that Minnesota beats anywhere is that we're better in winter. But even if we're better in winter, Minnesota tends to have the worst fucking.
You still tend to have a lot of people who don't fucking know how to drive in the winter.
Yeah, you'd think like Minnesota, it's regularly on a regular basis, it's -30°F, not including wind chill. And the roads are just always ice. It's just an ice rink. And you would.
Do you guys have moose in Minnesota?
We do at Moose Lake, of course. Yeah, we've
okay. See, that's a winter driver when there's a moose in the middle of the road and they can still go 50 down the road and miss the moose. That's a driver.
I missed the deer, and I almost murdered my friend. We rolled 3 times. I passed out. I didn't pass out. I got knocked out, and a 4-inch by 4-inch. What do they call it? Like a signpost, a 4-inch by 4-inch big ass signpost went through the windshield and it got stuck and it was in right at his heart and my best friend at the time's heart. It was scary. And he was on the phone with his girlfriend that I hooked him up with at the time, which I'm sure was scary for her. Woo, buddy. But I was
you know, all those times that you talk about being a good driver. Don't mention
Stan, you remember Shane.
Yep, and I remember how the van looked after all that shit happened. You guys should have been dead.
Yeah, we should have been dead. We hopped a. Oh my God, it's Josh Kuplik here.
Yeah. Yeah, you were too busy talking, and he's just sitting here quietly.
So,
Josh and
Stan both know where I'm talking about. On the way to Hastings, my old house off of 250th East, in middle of nowhere. It's a dirt road, straight shot. You take a left, go on a new trail to Hastings. On that dirt road, you shouldn't do 85 miles an hour. I was doing 85 miles an hour. And me and my brother did that all the time. It wasn't a big deal. Difference was this night a deer hopped out in front of us. It wasn't even wintertime. It was full-blown summer. Deer hopped out. When you do 85 miles an hour on a dirt road that's 2 inches thick of brand new gravel, let me tell you a secret. It'll flip. It'll flip real quick. We hopped the ditch. Whoop, 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 whoop. and this is something that I don't remember after this part, after I got hit with the telephone pole. We go and we jump like straight motocross. We clear it. We land on the other side. We come back up and out. And that's where the no trespassing sign, the no trespassing sign with the 4x4 post. Oh, thank you. God. Is that Pearl 6-5 motherfucking one? Uh-huh. Where is he? Where did he go?
I think so.
Pearl, where'd you go?
Let's backtrack real quick to, we were just talking about driving on winter roads, and you're like, oh yeah, I had this really shitty time in the summer.
Josh, if you guys don't know, which I'm sure you don't, I'm not cocky, but I don't believe I can get hurt.
He told me a story as soon as he got here. He said that he was going to go the other day when it was blizzarding. He decided he was going to
get Culver's.
Yeah, go get some food for the kids. And Mandy was like, why are you leaving? And he's like, oh, I can't get hurt.
And I...
Hashtag machine.
It's the truth. It's the truth. I don't believe that it's possible for me to get hurt in
Indestructible. It's just that he can't get hurt.
I can't get hurt. The only thing I think is might be my weakness, I haven't tried it yet, is like bullets, maybe. But even then, I still feel like I have a pretty solid chance that I'm going to win against a bullet. But
you could test it and have Mandy shoot you with a rubber bullet.
So there's a couple.
You've never broken a bone?
I told him he's Bruce Willis.
So there's a couple here in Minnesota.
Attaboy, I'm so glad.
Yes.
Well, let's bounce back a little further. But yeah, same thing. Side note, that was a good fucking movie too.
Anyways. If you guys aren't familiar with a YouTuber who was shot and killed by his girlfriend here in Minnesota.
Oh, I've seen that video.
Is Mandy listening right now? Don't talk
so
about
if you're not familiar. Oh God, what's wrong with
Never mind. She's killing him daily by the minute.
She poisoned the wine, I think.
No, so, I figured she was just climbing in behind him at some point.
Through his second puberty. Oh.
So listen, there's a couple here in Minnesota that she accidentally killed her boyfriend by shooting him in the chest. Now, to be completely fair,
he shielded himself with a fucking book.
Yeah, he put up several books. The thing is, though, is what a pussy. He died from a .22.
Oh God,
bro! If I was shot with I would deploy the .22 with my. I'm dead serious. He died. Oh girl! Oh no! It wasn't a .22. It was a fucking .38 special. It was a .38. Never mind. I'm so dumb. That was a different story.
We'll put it this way: there's a reason that in the electrical field we consider 120 volts the most dangerous.
Because you don't think it's dangerous.
Exactly.
Yes.
So if you were to use, you know, if it was not a .22, but if you're like, oh, what a bitch, she died from a .22. Well, yeah, maybe that makes it the more dangerous because it's not one that you would expect.
Oh, I forgot.
Point still being, yes, Perler, we did hear you for a second, and then it got quiet again.
What's so sad is that there were husband and girlfriend thing. A 20-year-old Minnesota woman whose quest for internet fame took a turn tragically fatally shot her boyfriend during a stunt intended for YouTube. She pleaded guilty to second-degree manslaughter. In June, Mona Lisa Perez. The thing is this woman is white as fuck, and her name is Mona Lisa Perez.
I'm sorry for the guy that died, but
look at her.
At the same point, what the fuck were you both doing?
Well,
this is going to be really cool. I'm unstoppable here with some books.
So I want to go ahead and just say something quick.
Did you kill him? Yeah, I did.
They're from Halstead, Minnesota, which if you're not familiar with the state, there's nothing above, Cambridge. So you have the Twin Cities, it's St. Paul, Minneapolis, very diverse, it's like basically a mini New York, Seattle situation. The further north you go, it gets whiter, more ice fishing, and all of a sudden the Klan shows up. These ones are in the middle of Klan country.
Oh wow!
And she looks white as fuck. Her boyfriend was Mexican.
Does,
I think
actually?
She looks like she was.
Yeah, she looks. Yeah, we hear you.
Yep.
Oh, cool.
The bullet goes through the book and entered Mr. Ruiz's chest, fatally wounding the 22-year-old. I guess the biggest thing is I want to know how the size of the book. because I feel like I want to try
a book
this
in front of me, bitch. That was a magazine,
right? So it was barely a pamphlet. So I would try this stunt. I would happily try this stunt
if it was like entire Webster's dictionaries.
If it was four Catholic Bibles,
for
if it was like a art history book for college, you could use that shit. Those are thick ass books.
Uh-huh. When I was going to school,
audio I used the entire encyclopedia from 1982.
Yes, before Google existed.
I was thinking A through M at least.
So in school, art or electrical encyclopedia, which I don't even want to know what your guys' looked like. Because we had to learn electrical because you're fucking working with 120 volts. 48 volts doesn't sound like a lot right up until you go to, it's not grounded, you put it in a fucking ribbon mic that takes 48 volt charge that has no ground. Believe me, the artist touches their face to it, they will have facial palsy for days.
I'll put it this way, voltage doesn't kill you, amperage does.
Amperage does, exactly. So the amount of amps that's going through that bitch.
The amount of electricity needed to stop your heart, if you put a metal on two sides of your chest, Chris, straight in front of your heart, you only need 7.5 watts.
Holy.
A Christmas light bulb can kill your heart.
Well, so that's my point. So in college,
so yeah,
the textbooks we had to read and we had to pass, like you couldn't just, it was a mandate that you're working with this equipment by the state. You are mandated to learn the same shit you learn in terms of Ohm's law and shit, not the crazy shit. Just that basic, the basics, you know what I mean? And that fucking book was
the good advanced shit.
The 1,200 page books you had to memorize certain portions of, the chapters were in hundreds of pages. Most chapters are like, you know, 20, 30 pages, hundreds. So that was one book. Mm-hmm. I want to know your textbooks. I'll fucking block it with 38 easy all day long. Real quick, don't fucking try this. I'm just kidding. These are all jokes, assholes.
We'll put it this way.
You could have just used the Harry Potter book shit. Those are thick ass books too.
Fucking Game of Thrones books? Holy shit.
Our textbooks weren't really that much. Like thick wise. They were pretty normal.
It's because you're like 12.
Even our code book is maybe an inch and a quarter thick.
Yeah, I remember my dad always going through his classes to stay up to date with his journeyman, and those books maybe were about this big.
Again, because your father is 12 years old. When I was going to college back in the
1800s, they're not as big as you'd assume. We'll put it that way.
I still have mine, and mine were fucking huge.
I still have all mine, too, but I mean...
No, but you went to college way later than I did, I think. You just finished, right?
I didn't go to college.
How come I can't get the video out?
I do not know.
Perler, I want to see you. I know you. I remember, but I can't see you, bro.
Yeah, I can't get the damn, I can't get the video to work.
I don't mean that. On the top of your right-hand corner, are you using Android or iPhone?
I'm using a Mac.
Okay, so that's...
Oh, it must be a Mac problem.
It's not. It's only because something's wrong going on. I would leave, sure. Josh, I want you to... I mean, Perler. Goddamn, TJ.
Close it down and
opening
it up
again. Yeah, and opening it up. That's the best way to fix any Mac.
I'll try that.
But yeah, even just like our testing instrument textbook was maybe an inch thick. Like they're not as big as they used to be. They're simplified now. They're less use smaller words because...
Well, because most millennials are dumb.
No, it's because either way, you're still looking at cutting cost. So if you can make a smaller words, you know, to shorten the amount of pages, okay, fine.
Hit that like button, my ninja kitties. So the smaller amount of pages, it's kind of like Pornhub.
Yes, see, hashtag McNasty. Books are obsolete compared to the 80s and 90s. That's true.
That's yeah, and I went to college way back then, in 2010 or 11.
Not even close. The 80s and 90s, and you're like, yeah, 2011. That was fucking 8 years ago.
It's the same shit. It's the same shit. Josh Cooper knows. Josh, let me ask you a question, bro. Can you hear us?
I think so.
How come Perler can't be seen?
I do not know.
I feel like he's a part of the CIA or he's like part of the Jewel company.
Wait.
Now he's spying.
By chance, do you have a Mac that you put a piece of black electrical tape over the camera?
Ha ha! That's me!
Does it look black?
Yeah, no. It's just a black screen for us.
Oh, my image. You guys hear about Cutwood going down and getting bought out by Big Pharma?
Yeah, that was a while ago, though, right?
Yeah.
I was going to say, what's his name? I don't want to say his real name, just get Paul Labworks.
Just go with
Labworks. I'm gonna say Labworks was talking about it.
Labworks,
literally like Labworks. 8 months ago, if we think about it, which is crazy. Before it happened, remember you were here. You were literally physically in the studio.
That was maybe.
It was before September. It was way before winter.
It was after we came back, though.
But 6 months ago then? Yeah. Either way, it's been a while.
There was some hearsay rumor info being passed. Well,
they tried going after Ruthless too, but yeah, Ruthless just has too many side companies as well. So they weren't going to take them out.
They're basically rappers. They have so many side bitches, it's hard to tell which one they're actually dedicated to.
Cannot do you buy clones?
You know, it probably doesn't help that I'm using Safari. I should probably use Chrome since it's a Google thing.
I was on my computer. I was pulling up on Explorer, and it was doing weird shit too. And it does work a lot better on Chrome, if that helps.
Yeah, I'll try that.
Chrome's where it's at, bro.
Yeah.
Yep, I can't do it on Explorer at all. I have to do it on Chrome.
Yeah. I don't know if it's a Google thing, whatever.
It's an Android thing, Google.
You know, you have Chrome on your Mac. That doesn't necessarily... Point on, we're going to move on.
I didn't know they had tobacco shows, right? Thank you guys for hitting that like button. Saint Lucie says, where are your favorite sites to buy seals for 25mm RTA tanks? I haven't purchased an O-ring ever because...
Well, you have a fucking...
plethora.
Yeah.
But if I was going to purchase O-rings, I guess my first place I would look is eBay, only because I can get them for so inexpensive.
Okay. Yeah. Honestly, I don't have nearly as much as you, but just from stuff that I've bought in the past.
Yep.
You know, there's same some thing. Extras. I got a couple that I still keep. But
I'm not using.
I have a hard time getting my top caps off of my RDAs. You know, like on the bonds of this little top cap little thing.
Sounds like you need to start doing there's some fucking curls, girl.
That Galatech that I have.
My
O-rings are wet, but it's...
Oh, there it goes.
There he is.
Hey. God damn. Where you at, dog? Specifically, where is... What's your address? But don't say it. I'm kidding. Where are you at? West side?
I live in West side. Oh, you were talking about it earlier.
I know, bro. Where at specifically on the west side?
You know where the Walmart is?
Of course I do. That's the Midway Walmart right by Home Depot and shit.
Yeah, I'm like literally like the next stop sign down from that Walmart on the other side of 52.
That's on the other side. So you live on the south side, South St. Paul side, but on the it's still on the west side.
No. Past the Walmart, coming from 52.
Oh, okay. Off of Thompson or Wentworth.
Yep, Wentworth. Yep,
Wentworth. There you go, Wentworth exit. We literally passed your house. An hour and a half ago, literally past your house an hour and a half ago.
Yeah, we had to go pick up Mandy.
Yeah. Right after we were coming off Lafayette on the right hand side, I was like, yep, there's Perler right there. Bro, do you know how many times I've seen people walk across the walking bridge, like going from the west, you know, the west side of 52 to the east side, and they hold up those signs, like protest signs. Mm-hmm. And I've seen, like, literally just driving, coming off of Cesar Chavez on 52, you see people getting into fights. Like, literally three or four people just run towards whoever's holding the fucking sides and just bop, 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 bop. I filmed music videos on that fucking bridge. If you if you guys delve into my history, you'll see some fucked up shit on what was he saying? Music video-wise. What are you vaping at, Perler?
I got my Orion here. Well, actually, I got two of them now.
Is that the and, key?
No, these are both the DNA chip ones.
Fancy.
And I'm vaping on some twisty salt juice. Some pink
How is it?
Ice pink crunch. I really like the twist brand of V juice, man. They got some good flavors. I like their freebase too. It's a really sweet though.
I've only tried the freebase. I haven't tried the salt. And to be completely honest, I only tried one of their liquids out of the whole line. I couldn't even tell you. I remember I gave them all away for the Patreon giveaway. That would have been over the summertime when I gave them away. So have you tried the Quest, the Orion, the Q?
I have not, no.
He fucking loves it.
The only reason why I would wish it was a little bit better is because of the adjustability. That's the one thing I miss on the DNAs. The biggest part about the DNA I didn't like is it bricked. That simple, both of them. So, but I also got the first batch.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, I had the same issue. I was commenting about it a couple episodes ago. But when, what's his name with the beard? When he had his issue.
You're going to have to be a little specific.
Andrew. Andrew, yeah.
Right. When he had his issue with the Orion, I had just got my Orion, you know, and the ticket placed and all that stuff. So like I was like, what the heck? You know, I tried to figure out if anybody knew what the heck was going on with it, and well, apparently mine was one of the first ones affected too. But so, I bought it like right after you told me about it.
The biggest issue I have with DNA right now is that I put in a ticket and it's been three weeks. It's been since the end of February or January.
And wow, my turnaround was so quick, man. It was like literally the next week. It was like a week later from the day I sent it in, I had it back.
No, that's what I'm trying to say, is they haven't even sent me an email to ship it. I still have it. It's still sitting on the bench in the garage.
Even when I asked him about that one, the 75 that I'm working on.
Maybe it's me.
It was a day, and I got a response back about it.
Mine, it took 3 or 4 days for them just to accept the ticket, like meaning like accept my email that I sent, and then they wanted me to refill out the form. I'm telling you,
they're busy.
They have something against Mac. That's what it is. What the fuck it is. Joshua Kuplik, because of the person that's on the screen right now, guys, I've now made two, they're not finished, but I made all the planks for the RDA, for several RDA synths, two of them at least. This kid watching right now, who's looking like he's playing a video game and not paying attention at all, that kid. So I want everyone to throw a like on the fucking like buttons, because I'll be giving those, they're fucking gorgeous pieces of red oak. They're not oak. I don't know what they are. They're fucking blood red pieces of wood. I physically went over there, and him and I loaded those bitches up into a Toyota Highlander. Excuse me. That was my Russian accent, the Highlander. And then he proceeded to show me some sexy ass restored truck that I want really bad, until I found out that his stepdad put 60 grand into it. And I was like, I'm good, thanks. Talk, Josh. Say hi. Do something. Fuck, we can't hear you.
No hero. Bring up a topic I was curious in just about.
The what?
Do you care if I bring up a topic I was just curious about?
Dude, bro, bring up whatever you want. Dick size, all that shit.
Cool.
Yeah,
cool.
There's not much of
it. That was actually what I was going for. No, I'm just kidding. No, but I was wondering what you carry.
What'd you what?
What do you carry?
Oh, so my daily carry is a just because I don't trust fucking YouTube and shit. Is a Ruger 38 or 380, okay. Ruger 380. It's just a little guy, and I used to carry a Smith & Wesson 40 full size M&P military police, and but I sold it.
That one?
Yeah, that little baby one. Yeah, yeah. My Ruger's tiny, but the thing is, because like when you first buy a pistol, especially when you go to class, like I went to classes for it and shit, and they tell you, you know, you want stopping power, and I bought a full size military police 40.
Ooh.
Granted, yeah. And so I bought a tiny one, the shield, the Smith & Wesson shield, and then I was like, it's 4th of July, of course it's on sale. So for like a $600 pistol, I think I paid like $350, $370, $380, something like that. And then I got the warranty, all shit. At the end of the day, I looked stupid. Like I was walking around with a limp, like I had a stick in my ass, because I had a full size 14 round pistol in my fucking ass crack, and it was just not a good idea. So now I sold that to my nephew, and he got a super good deal on it. He loves it. He fucking loves it. Congratulations, because I can't carry it. Well, how about you, bro?
I carry a Glock 19.
Of course you do.
Gen 5.
God, you're fancy. That's why. You got DNA Orions, two of them, and of course you have a Glock.
I did.
That just comes along with the territory.
I was told to play something, if you don't mind.
Yeah, of course. Put it the mic.
I heard this story of someone contacting you the other day.
And then I walked towards the lights, and I'm like, oh, baby.
This is Goodbye Horses by Hugh Lazarus.
You gotta say,
apparently Nos was just
going to town.
you gotta say the Jay and Silent Bob quote.
That's right. No, we're not even gonna go there. We're just gonna go ahead and leave it alone.
I
right there.
Filled the cup.
Hey, they're bringing. It's coming back, though. Honestly, they're bringing it back.
Oh, I know. Nice. I almost joined
Bob reboot.
I almost joined for $100 on Legion. Mm-hmm. You guys know what I'm talking about?
Yep.
Where you invest? Yeah. Oh, yeah. I saw that shot on Instagram, and I was scrolling by, and I went, wait, back up. And I clicked on that shit. I was like, oh, it's $100 to join to invest on fucking something. It was one of my dad's favorite movies. That one in Constantine. And that'll give you an idea. My dad's
That's a weird mix, but all right.
It is. And my old man's the one who introduced me to hip hop too. So like
I'm super into Constantine.
Yes.
Well, it's Jane's hat.
Well,
I hope they make a Constantine part two, though, honestly.
You and me, it's one of my favorite movies of all time, bro. All time. Constantine.
Oh yeah.
That's pretty good.
When I was 7 or 8, my dad handed me a cassette tape of This Is For La Raza by Kid Frost.
And
that was my introduction to hip hop. And then after that, my dad gave me a cassette tape of Lighter Shade of Brown Sunday afternoon. That fucking whole album.
How about that Mentirosa by Mellow Man Ace?
Yeah, bro. Yeah.
Yeah, man.
Tristan Lequentes, dude. Like, I was fucking on that shit, bro. It's a one black kid on the squad. You kill. Oh my god, on the squad. You know, let's go ahead and play that shit. Tres Delincuentes. Oh my god, like it's one of the greatest songs. The melody in this song is if you love hip hop, you know this track. And watch us lose 26 viewers right now.
Hey, we're at 34, so I mean it's not too bad.
Damn it. So like if you guys are familiar with old school hip hop, this is about as classic as it gets, specifically for West Coast. Why we were listening to it in Minnesota, I don't know. But it all resonated. It was all on the west side off of Roby. Off of Roby and like Stryker Avenue and shit on the
Hey man. Minnesota's Latino community is popping.
It's popping. And no one believes me. I was talking to Avalanche, I was talking to Ray about this. I was talking about so many people. You go to Montana, you go to fucking, we're like cockroaches. You can't kill us. We're breed like fucking rabbits. It's just, you kill 6 of us, there's 19 more that's gonna move in. So what do you just join? Don't try to remove, bro. Build a wall, yes. We'll find a tunnel. You feel me?
Look,
and I went to Johnson, man. That's, you know, right in the hood. You know, that's where all the Mexicans are.
Yeah,
I heard this great comment today that walls work when we could only walk.
We got airplanes and I don't know, tunnel diggers.
When you're in the fucking air, you don't need them.
Anyway. So, bro, I went to school at St. Matt's. You know where St. Matt's, Humboldt, and Cherokee, and then Henry. Okay. Yeah. And then I went to a lot of different high schools. I picked out a bunch of them. Chrissy, how come you seem so huffing and puffing?
I just took my top half off and I'm having problems with my O-rings because this fucking copper thing keeps ripping them up.
Oh, on the Bonza?
I had the same.
That's a pretty common issue on the Bonza.
That Galatech that I got from you that I still fucking use for flavor tasting.
I love the Galatech.
That thing chewed.
All of the green O-ring Asmodus uses, and I told him, like, listen, Eddie, I love you. You're amazing. He took my fucking napkin drawing and turned it into a real thing.
Yeah.
And I'm like, listen.
He's not kidding about the napkin drawing.
Yeah. And it was on graph paper, but it was still pretty napkin drawn-y. Like, you just saw what I designed earlier, like literally for 30 seconds.
Yeah.
30 seconds. And I guarantee you that will be an RDA. And I told him, like, we are not using the green O-rings. He's like, oh, why not? Bro, they fucking suck, dude. They're beautiful. That I like to look at them. They're Asmodus's thing, but I also don't want your gross thing on my stuff.
They look good. When it's top cap off
for Instagram,
for a picture,
look good for Instagram.
Okay, fine, but
yeah, they don't work that well on the Vice RDA either.
No, yeah, they don't.
They're just kind of cheap.
Well, they work well on my C4. I love them on my C4. I never changed them once.
Maybe not price cheap, but it seemed like a cheap quality.
His response was, they're great because they're really fat and they're really squishy. That might be great for a BBW Pornhub video,
but it's not a good thing.
Yeah, it's not the same thing on an RDA, bro. Like, Asmodee, it's so funny because, like, they're never really known for their tanks. They're never really known for their RDAs. They make beautiful mods, high-end, yep, gorgeous mods, and, like, not low-end, but, mid-range metal mods that have a great – and my favorite part about Asmodee is that they'll put a high-end chip in a regular-ass mod, and then they'll come out 6 months later with the high-end version of the shit they should have came out with before.
No, I do have something I was going to say, and I noticed it on your last video with the Lux. Is it because you're going with them that you stopped calling them ass modest?
It's because, no, the reason why is because
I realized he's like, oh my God, he said fucking, he fucking said Asmodus.
He said it right. Oh my God.
I never noticed that you said it Asmodus wrong. I always thought you said it right, but not until you said it. Said Asmodus.
Asmodus.
Right.
He always says Asmodus.
And the reason why.
And all of a sudden it's like, fuck, he said Asmodus.
The reason why I said it correctly was specifically because of this fool literally started to, I never was called out on that. Not one person that I remember anyway ever said anything about it. And Josh was like, you know, you're saying it wrong. I'm like, well, I'm going to continue to say it wrong, asshole. But he made me so self-conscious about it. I had to like edit. I literally edited those parts in and out where I said Asmodus. My favorite, one of my favorite squonker devices of all time is still the pumper. And I still call it, it's the ass pumper. Like, I just, it's just what it is. It's the ass pumper. Man. But it's one of my favorite mods, but I'm still going to call it, it's hilarious. Don't call your shit the ass what? Ass mod.
Look, if your name is already pretty close to ass,
and mod,
don't make a mod that's called the pumper.
It's the ass caucus, bro. Like, it just is what it is.
It's kind of setting yourself up. So it is. But I mean, then again, it's funny. So, all right, fuck it.
The biggest reason I didn't end up by calling my RDA the nasty RDA is because, like, I can just picture Matt from stuff like, it is the nasty because it fucking sucks. Like, some dumb shit like that.
No, it would show up on his. No, we'll change it. It'll show up on Jason's doorstep.
Yes.
He'll open it up. He's like, that's why he called it the nasty, because it's full of grease.
Yes. Yeah. It's full of machine oil.
So, how's
what is it?
On your
what?
How's progress on your RDA coming?
Good. We got two different designs down for the deck, and then the first one to admit, the deck. I remember the whole thing about the napkin design. I didn't design the deck very well, and they made the deck for me too. Like, but I feel like one of those. I feel like I don't know how to explain it. I feel like a little bit like like if any of you guys have kids. If you're a five-year-old, is a dad, when I grow up, I want to be a dragon. I'm like, yeah, of course you do. That's all right. Yeah, you're gonna be a dragon. So when I'm working with Asmus, Eddie is like the dude I'm working with is a really good fucking designer. Like, I sent him the fucking drawing. He had the 3D graphic rendering within hours. He's like, we can't do it right now. We have a really small facility. We're a handmade company. We don't do shit like in giant clumps. He's like, you're gonna have to give us a couple of months. I'm like, all right.
Oh darn.
Yeah, shucks. And so I show him the top guy. He's like, bro, he's like, I'm in love with your design. And then I send him the deck. He goes, sure, we'll do that. And then I get a message 3 months later. He's like, bro, this fucking deck sucks. it's like it's hot, it's spit back, it fucking sucks. And I'm like, I told you, go with a post. Can't say it. Like, go with a different deck.
Go with this style instead.
Go with this style instead. And he's like, that's what I thought. And like, yes, why didn't you just say that to begin with, though? Like, I told him, I'm like, look, I didn't put much thought into the deck. The whole point of this RDA is the top cap. Like, the top cap is flawless. He's like,
the
top cap
is the
it's never been
staple
done.
Staple of it.
Yes, it's the staple. It's never been done. I've had the design since 2015. He's like, it's great. It's phenomenal. The deck you may as well throw in the trash. And I said, you're the fucking designer, goddammit. Not me. Do the fucking deck. Get it right. And I told him what I wanted. And he's like, it's already been done. I'm like, it's fine. The deck's not the important part. So that's been the experience so far, bro. Thank you for asking, by the way. More importantly,
Yeah, I and it comes through the speaker. Face gets to bumping, rookers get to bumping. Who's that rocking? Got the waterboard jumping, blasting through high. I mean, from the boom.
And so on and so forth, like Los Nativos type status. Oh my God, he's a midget. I never noticed there was a midget in this video. Watch, he's skateboarding. It's the first, it's either the Mexican Mini-Me, watch. Or not Mini-Me, what is
the
his name?
Wee Man,
Mexican Wee Man.
Oh, oh it is Wee Man! Holy shit, that's Wee Man! Yes, Wee Man is Mexican.
No, he's not.
Yes, he is.
Holy fuck, yes, I know.
Yeah.
He's got a taco restaurant in LA called Wee Man Chronic Tacos.
Watch, wait.
There. Jason Acuna.
Oh my God. Acuna.
Yes, yep.
Acuna. Get the fuck yes. Us.
I think it was Brad Williams made fun of him. He's like, people come up to me and they're like, oh, I didn't know you were a comedian. And he's like,
and you like tacos.
He's like, because I loved you on Jackass. And he's like, I'm not Wee Man. and then I met him and he said his name was Jason Acuna. And he's like, wait, so you're a midget and you're Mexican? How the hell did you get over the fence?
Hey guys, I'm going to sign off for a sec to try to figure out my RDA right now.
What's going on with the the trouble?
The O-rings are all fucked up, mostly because it just keeps shredding them.
Can you send me the picture? I'll text him to Bogan, and I'm not name dropping. I'm just saying, if we can prevent shit like that from happening as a reviewer, I think you would appreciate that.
The Bonzo 1.5 point. Bye.
So send me pictures before you
report.
Yeah, I got
it. All right, we'll do. I'll be right back.
All right.
I got a Bonzo 1.5 that I ordered. Is just RDA by itself, and
I love
the tolerance on the tops are so tight, like I can't even adjust the airflow on this. It's ridiculous. I don't know.
Perler, did you get your package?
No, I was going to pick it up, but I've been having car problems and stuff.
Oh, so it did get there, though. Specifically, you live less than 15 minutes from each other.
You sent the package to me?
Yes.
Oh, I didn't pay for shipping. I was planning on picking it up, so.
Oh, you know who did? You know who paid your shipping? Josh.
Who?
The one that's on screen right now.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So tell Josh, thank you. He has no idea.
He's still just like,
no idea.
Searching porn. Searching for porn.
Between Josh, Shannon Smith, I'm trying to think, Ray, like the anytime someone doesn't pay for shipping, those guys, like they fucking, they pull forward. They do it.
Nice.
And so those guys, yeah, so send shipping, that's great. But they're the ones that pay when no one else does. It's all right. It's all good. But hold on, real quick, before I forget, the most important thing in the world is.
¿Qué onda, muchacho? Ahí vienes, te miro. Si me traes bronca, me loco, de a tiro, me paro, te tumbo. No es tu rumbo, y con el lingo tal vez te confundo. Here's the attack with the 5 foot 10. The blacks again, once again, with the cop dipped in. As I emerge from the depths of the realm, my son, I got the black,
forgot how bad this music
is. One black skin on the squad, you don't test. Sitting hard like a nasty, swift like a Zulu. That's what it's like with the pump shot.
I get goosebumps from this track. This one is like 93 till infinity. That beat specifically, bro, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I get Pauly Shore about it. 93 till infinity. This instrumental, or this track in general, but this instrumental specifically by Souls of Mischief. Oh my God. If you don't know hip hop, like, if you don't know this track, you don't know hip hop. That's end of story. Oh my God. Bro, I recorded in studios that looked just like that. Granted, we had a computer back then. I don't know what they had, like a fucking like Atari or something. But either way. Listen to the beat drop. Listen to it. So I don't like Souls of Mischief. I just like the instrumental and the actual tracks done after that. But specifically, God damn. Here it comes. Watch this beat drop. Ah! I was 3 years old, and I still got so much love. So much
You
respect.
Need a towel to clean up with? Just checking.
I got Captain Underpants. Or Captain America Underpants, rather. Yeah. So hold on. Roy Nelson says, I don't know how. Well, can you read this? I can't. Roy Nelson, it's like if you don't know how you know Ninja. Ha. Oh, Roy! Roy! Roy's been a part of the channel, bro, since long time. Since 2014. Good. Should we read Ray's letter out loud?
Sure.
We're going to read Ray's letter. I have no
idea. Now, before you fully show this, he wrote a nice little letter and then PS'd it with the biggest fucking words in the world.
Pacific good. We are going to listen to Jocko. We'll link. Avalanche, you know. Avalanche knows.
Yep.
The rest of you guys understand, but Avalanche is the only one that I can genuinely relate to. You know what happened when I sent Josh the Brian Cox episode of Rogan? He looked at his phone and put it back down.
Yeah. Oh, shit.
That's what I do.
Avalanche, no. He doesn't understand. He knows. There's a difference.
That's fine.
Hey, Nas. I'm going to block out that. Well, it's in the right order. Hey, Nas and Josh. First things first. Fuck. Sorry it took so long to get these clothes out to you.
You know what? You can say all you want. It came to me first.
I hope to get to you guys well and not damaged. Well, I'll see, because Josh might fuck shit up on purpose. I put some pairs of coils in the set as usual. I also tossed in some single coils for single coil option for RDAs in the future. Single coils RDAs might be coming out as well. Wink, wink. They're all 3mm coils, and Josh has all the night. Why do you have all the nichrome?
Continue reading.
Nichrome coils. And Nas has Dupuy's Cantal Cord nichrome wrap. Okay. All right.
That's why.
That's fair.
I got the nichrome coils because you got the can.
Some are wrapped with 36 gauge and some are with 38 gauge nichrome. All are alien. Are you gonna play Call of Duty afterwards, please?
Sure.
All right.
Sure, that's fine.
38 gauge nichrome. All the aliens are 3mm, 36 gauge. Well, then I think that is all. If you have any questions, just hit me up. Love you guys both, and thank you for all that you do. All that you both do. I had to read it like 6 times to make sure I wasn't seeing shit on the interwebs. I also tossed in some other items for you guys. You will know what they are for. Do you know what they are for? Don't end a sentence in a fucking preposition, motherfucker. Catch y'all on the flip-flop.
This is on the internet. We don't care about it.
Ray Lopez, a.k.a. RU462, a.k.a. The Pumpkin King, a.k.a. R2D2, P.S. Good. Now... I am going to make it my mission. I told man, you're adorable, Ray. LabWork says, Sin, Chemical Brothers are later in the scene. That's right. Off to the lawns. Have fun. LabWorks, love you, bro. What does he mean by lawns? Does he know what that means in America?
Maybe he's going to go mow.
These his pubes are like literally his fucking lawn.
I don't know. Either way, have fun and good.
Good. So let's go ahead and type in Jocko Willink. And we're going to listen to good quick, okay? And if we lose viewers, I don't give a fuck. I really don't give a fuck.
Don't get me wrong. I know we're good. Right.
No, not you. I'm not talking about you. I want TJ specifically. Can I ask you a question, bro, real quick?
Of course, man.
Not only do you look familiar, but I know you personally.
Well, yeah, man. We were at I met you at my great grandma's and great grandpa's anniversary.
I told you it was him. I had pictures with him at Aunt Lucy's. I told you.
Yeah, man. They're my great grandma. Well, you know,
and then he never told me shit.
I said those words on like 5 or 10 live streams ago. I'm like, I think he's related to me, bro.
No.
I said that. Are you sure? Maybe it was Mandy.
it was probably Mandy.
You know Paula?
Yeah, of course.
Okay. Her daughter, Rhonda, her oldest daughter, is my mom.
No.
Yeah.
How old are you, 9?
I'm 25.
I'm like 20,
26 bro. This month.
Literally 25 years older than you.
Yeah. Literally, not literally.
We should do a Nas and Josh, Would You Rather.
We'll do that. As a matter of fact, as we as this video plays, we're gonna go ahead and put some would you rather questions. Bam.
All right. I was asked a pretty interesting one. I gotta run by you guys.
Oh shit. All right. If you got some ready, we'll pull the trigger. Hold on. Let's go ahead and play good quick. This is gonna get everyone amped. Do you remember when I texted you the other day and I told you I granted it was a bad paragraph? And I said we've run through a wall and things like that.
Yeah, what the fuck was that?
That was because I was listening to Rogan. Go ahead, read it. Read it.
Verbatim. I'm gonna read it for you.
Verbatim. What the fuck is this? Harvard? Just say you're reading it word for word.
Where are you? There you are.
If y'all hit the like button, your grandmother's back will not be broken.
Oregon. Okay, here it is. Oregon's literally playing the good video as I type this emoji. Get up, dust off, reload, recalibrate, re-engage, and go on the attack. Bro, I want to run they a fucking wall right now. And all I could say was, what?
Oh, fuck.
Thanks. I was lost. Anyway.
So, anyway.
On with let's the go ahead and play it.
Bye. Direct sport is one of my guys that worked for me. He would call me up some major problem, some issue that was going on, and he'd say, boss, we got this and that and the other thing. And I'd look at him and I'd say, good. And finally one day he was telling me about some issue that he was having, some problem, and he said, I already know what you're gonna say. And I said, well, what am I gonna say? He said, you're gonna say good. He said, that's what you always say. When something is wrong and going bad, you always just look at me and say, good. And I said, well, yeah. When things are going bad, there's going to be some good that's going to come from it. Didn't get the new high-speed gear we wanted? Good. Didn't get promoted? Good. More time to get better. Oh, mission got canceled? Good. We can focus on another one. Didn't get funded. Didn't get the job you wanted. Got injured. Sprained my ankle. Got tapped out. Good. Got beat. Good. Unexpected problems. Good. We have the opportunity to figure out a solution. That's it. When things are going bad, don't get all bummed out. Don't get startled. Don't get frustrated. Yes! If you can say the word good, guess what?
Good.
It means you're still alive. Oh. It means you're still breathing. And if you're still breathing, well, now.
Yes!
You still got some fight left in you.
Right!
So get up, dust off, reload, recalibrate,
run through a fucking wall.
Re-engage.
Yes!
And go out on the attack.
I think you forget that this is like the 4,000th time you've shown me this.
I'm going to show you. I'm listening for me.
Good.
You broke your elbow. Good.
I broke my elbow, but good. You know why? Because next week it'll be stronger, sort of. That's right.
No.
Love you, Ray. Nadia Cabrera. Vape says, my whole life story. That's right. You mad, bro? You mad, bro? Play End of Days, Nas. I will play End of Days.
Look, I've been holding back so many times, but now that's all I'm going to say.
And listen, look at the bottom of my mouth. Yeah.
That was
beautiful. That was beautiful. I have no complaints. Christy, are you back now? Are your O-rings okay or not?
Yes, they're beautiful now, but now I have to re-wick it because I realized it was disgusting.
Congratulations. You know what? That's a good thing.
You know what? Good.
I ended up using my drop-dead O-rings. Good.
That's right. Frank Wiener, good. You know what? Less children. Fine. Does your boyfriend vape, Christy?
Yes, he does, but he doesn't rebuild.
Good. Want to know. He doesn't build? Oh, my God. You do, though.
Yeah.
Christy, you're a fucking gangster.
They look good.
God. I'm working on making my own coils, but Ray's gonna help me with it because I'm having trouble. When you look,
all right, coils,
good.
Me too.
She should start off how I started. I just started building coils off of watching Twisted Messes. Honestly, that's how I started.
I started mostly because I didn't know what I was doing, and I just did it. I refused.
Same
to
here.
At the beginning, I refused to watch other reviewers and shit. When I first saw Rip Trippers' How to Build or How to Do Aliens or some shit, or Clapton's, I mean, I specifically didn't watch. Like, I've never, and this is honest to God truth, I've never watched another reviewers or another builder on how to build Clapton's and Aliens, and none of that shit. It's also the reason why I don't know how to do them. Like Aliens and Staples and Juggernauts, but at the same time, like, it's hard. Good.
I watched a bunch of those videos and it really didn't help me very much. I had to figure it out by myself.
Juggernauts are easier than you think they are, honestly.
No, they're not.
Yes, they are.
Good.
I will make some and I will send you some.
Please do.
Somebody I saw.
I would love it. Thank you.
They had a short video on Instagram the other day. They were making Staples, and it was like, that looks fucking gorgeous. It's just a bunch of Claptons that they took and they kind of spaced everything out a little more and then just sat there and wrapped real slow. It's like, it makes sense in my mind. I mean, it's pretty. It looks cool. It looked really nice. So
let me just go ahead and say, I'm eating some sriracha hummus. Good. And it's not so. And it's not sriracha.
I was waiting for the setup and it landed.
And you, if you would have waited 13 seconds more, it would have been better. I'm eating sriracha hummus. My throat hurts. So it's not sriracha. It's goddamn tapatio. It's false advertising. I'm so pissed off right now. I'm eating Greek Mexican food. It's the most bizarre. What do you call that? Bizarre combination.
Good.
Fucking jock. Guys,
hey, what did what did you think of Smok's new pod system that's kind of a rip-off design of the Mi Pod?
Good.
Mi Pod got their product ripped off. NASA's response? Good.
Rip Trippers has sweaty knuckles. Good.
Did you guys ever see my Rip Trippers parody? We will be giving away the unicorns. These, what are they called?
Mustache and goatee.
I don't know.
What are they?
You got to open them up first.
Okay.
Can we get a sneaky peeky?
Oh yeah. Okay, because we got the gold.
Boss has armpits wet.
I do. Look at this good bitch right here. This gorgeous, high end, $100,000 per RDA. I'll be giving away next Thursday. I got another one right here. It's good. Look at that one.
You can look them sweaty up and see them. They're called the Axial.
The Axial by Mass Mods. Not Mom.
AXIAL.
Axial by Mass Mods. We have many of them.
It's fucking gorgeous. Many. It's all metal.
It's all, including the drip tip. God damn it. Real quick.
I think I've seen Jay's review on those.
Dick good trip.
When you say dick trip instead. Dick trippers. Okay, so let's go ahead and type in dick trippers vaping with thesis quick. This is the old school. So
these things are fucking beautiful though.
What was it called?
I don't know. I don't know what
it's probably one of the funniest videos I've ever been a part of. Oh, there it is. There it is. It's got a 54% rating.
Oh, that one, yes.
It's got a which is stupid because it's genuinely one.
It's the
where did it go?
The parody. Someone has
Rip Tripper's like mask.
Not someone. It's over his face. two of my friends. Oh my god, I'm old as so fuck. Look at this. I used to be famous as fuck. This
and yes, depressing. He was in there being like the redneck.
Yeah.
With a fucking trucker hat or something.
Let's go ahead and say, I'm going to reply to a 3-year-old comment. Love you. Mwah. I just replied to them. Joshua Helms. Oh, fuck. Oh, Josh. I didn't know that was your last name. Sorry, bro. 492 likes and 417 dislikes on this video. And this is genuinely one of the funniest videos I've ever been a part of in my entire life. If you guys have 17 minutes, I promise you, good. You will not regret it.
I think the best part of that was when he's sitting there and he tries to ask him a question about something and he's just dead quiet.
He's like, if I start talking shit to you, or if I start asking you questions, answering these questions, I gotta answer all these questions. Remember guys on the YouTube channel, hold on.
Oh, it was damn funny.
Say the term, I got all these vapes. So there's this dude in Texas, two of them. The one I still don't agree with on anything, but he's a cool person, I guess. But his friend, who I've never seen his face ever, no one has. He's like Mankind from WWF. His friend was one of the funniest people I've ever met in my entire life. So if you guys go to Joshua Helms' channel, it's called Vaping with Friends, Season 1, Episode 6, Rip Tripper's Secrets Revealed. And it's genuinely one of the funniest videos, not only that I've ever been a part of, that I've ever seen. Because of the dude wearing the mask, should be a comedian.
It's fucking perfect.
And he's shy. He genuinely refuses to ever go on stage. It's fucking... And I'm in the video. This video is 10 years old. Think about that. Or four, because I can't count. 4 years old. And it's great.
Hey, guys. Vaping with Friends. Matt and Hardigan here.
I'm going to fast forward to the point where Rip Tripper shows up.
He's very Mr. Rip Trippers.
Hey, what is going on? Thank you for having me. I brought you a little something for the wall. That's on the wall right there. I wasn't at home, now I'm at home. Except for I'm in your garbage palace, which is your home. I didn't mean to offend. It's just kind of like a garbage compared to mine.
You can have all your trash talk on me.
I didn't mean to do that to you. Did you feel like I did that?
A little bit.
I treated you like a mud cat in a waller hole. I didn't mean to do that. Normal people have a gerb hut. At least you have a palace made of garbage. That's French, my friends. French for America. So real. What's up? It's great to be here, Matter. I'm more on it than a duck on a June bug to be here right now, and I'm excited to be in your studio. Well, slick as ice in here.
You're kind of
what?
Kind of
bonding. Hey, listen, you invited me to your home. Don't get mad at me if I'm going to try to get up in your business, all right? I'm here today to talk to you about my new coil build. Is that why I'm here?
No.
Why am I here today?
Well, I mean, we're going to talk. My show is more history, what brought you to where you are.
You know what? Lights give me a real bad glare on the George W. Bush. Hallelujah, America. No. Not necessarily, unless you want to.
I mean, what are your views?
My views? I don't wear glasses, if that's what you mean. I don't wear contacts either. There's a big thing going on that I wear contacts, okay? I don't wear contacts. I have perfect vision.
It's a little intimidating, honestly.
Yeah, don't be scared of me. Listen, I'm here. I want to talk about my new build. I'm working on a new build right now. It's called the Tortuga de Negro. Black pearl to my Hispanic friends, okay? I got another one coming out. It's called the government. You don't want that thing looking in on you. It is. Tastes like blood and mint. Write that down. On my show, I got things that pop up. I need people to read.
Hello.
Your show is sick as tits. I didn't mean to interrupt you again, but this whole place is nice. There we go. All right. I like dogs. Now, I like to be around dogs, but I can't. I'm highly allergic to the dogs. My sniffer don't work when you're around them dogs. I put up pictures of dogs in my house because I can't get near them diggity dog.
What got you started in in YouTube?
Well, first I was just going to be Tripper, all right, because I fell down a lot as a child. But then I started chugging them rips, and I'm like, wait a minute. If I'm going to rip and I'm going to trip, then I'll be the Rip Trip. People always like, Rip, you're taking money. You're doing this. You're doing that. Well, guess what? Yeah, I love money. I can't have a dog. I have painted pictures of dogs. If I get around a dog, I'll get all stuffed nose.
I think people want to know things. I'm going to sort of ask the questions.
Okay.
I think that a lot of your viewers that maybe watch this.
This is the part where that come in, but it's funnier than just me. You got to watch this dude specifically.
A lot of questions for you.
Sure.
And so I thought maybe I would ask you a few that I've sort of gotten in before the show here.
Lay them questions on.
Okay, so what are your dog's names? The pictures of the dogs on the wall, I guess? And
it's just dead silence.
He won't talk.
Okay, I'll do another one. Okay, what made you start vaping?
Listen, I sit here and answer all these questions, but if I answer these questions you're asking me right now, right in front of you, I have to answer every single question. She over there asked me questions. I got to answer it. That person over there asked me questions. I would love to sit here and answer questions with you. I mean, I flew all the way down here. I'm right in your face. It would be extremely convenient, and I could have answered easier than me giving you this spiel right now. But I cannot do that, okay? Because look at me. I'm as clean as a catfish belly, and I can't be in here answering these questions. I got to answer my questions. Sorry, not sorry. I'm sorry. I'm not sorry.
What's your, like, travel kit?
I bring it all. I bring every single thing I have.
All these nights.
What? I got a big backpack. I got this one, this one, this one. I got all these things. I got a big backpack. I got this one, this one, this one. I got all these vapes. Now, this one, I got this new build I want to talk about right now. The Appalachian Hoopla. Oh, shit. I got a new sick build I want to talk about in this one right here. It's called the Give Me Your Money Build. Basically, and then you build your own. Give me your money, Bill. Basically, you give me your money, and then I have it. And then you build your own foil. Between 80 and 110% of my time directly in front of a video camera, I spend between only 10% of 100% of the time. Figure that math equation out. Math. Figure that out, man. All right, right now, there it is in front of you. Calculate it. All right, that's how much time I spend doing these videos. There, Slick.
What do you eat?
When it's in front of me. I got my own stuff coming through the pipeline, baby. It's fog juice. Wait, no, fog souls. Fog souls. It's not one word. It's two words, but put into one. When you go to the website and check it out, it's fog souls. Hold on a minute. Do you mind? I have a FaceTime coming in here.
Yeah,
there
was.
This is the favorite with his part. But I promise it's funny.
Well, hey, here.
You just,
if you watch it visually,
this lovely assistant.
Right there, yeah.
Your name is Donna. You are a man. Here, Donna. Make this come up on the big screen.
Hey, buddy, I'm one of your biggest fans. I'm a bigger fan of you than Dolly Parton is of Silicon. Let me ask you a question.
Yeah.
What would you like to be a true patriot, a real American? How's that feel deep down inside being red, white, and blue, going for the Eagle? NASCAR, woo!
Let me tell you something, all right, right now. I know what you're thinking. I'm in the NASCAR. Everybody's always like, you're in the NASCAR. Go fast. Go to the house. I don't like NASCAR. I'm sick of NASCAR.
Go fast. Go to the house.
Go fast. Go to the house. I don't like NASCAR. I'm sick of NASCAR. I'm sick of all them tires, okay? You know how much rubber is put into the ground each year? We don't need all that rubber. All that rubber, okay?
What? Put that one down here? Maybe.
What are you talking about? Gotcha. We don't need all that rubber. No rubber's necessary. Now, how does it feel to be? Why don't you shut up trying to answer some of these questions to my fan?
No rubber's necessary.
No rubber's necessary. Yes. Oh, you're being gross. I didn't mean to call you stupid. Now, listen, if I go calling you stupid, I'm going to have to call everybody stupid. I'm just going to take up between 80 and 90% of my time. 80 and 90.
Question. Why do you feel it's necessary to play with your ball when you're playing a game of golf? You play golf? That's a sissy game. Why do it?
Why play golf? Why play golf? I admire a good cut grass. How do they get it so short? I don't even play the game. I can play for a little bit. I can tell you all day about how well grass grows. Come on.
Hopefully that answers your question there.
Shut up.
How do you feel about Bobby kissing damn head or mannequin in his bedroom? What's up, propane and propane accessory?
I don't want to judge someone. Gavel sound, gavel sound. I keep chugging, but I ain't judging. Keep on chugging. No more judging. But you, sir, what?
It's chucking.
Oh. No more chucking. Keep on judging. Wait. More chucking. Less judging. I'm upset at this guy's Hank Hill impression. Let me tell you how to do a proper Hank Hill impression.
Never
bother you. I can't do it either. The future is now. Shut up. Matter. How about that one? That was the timeline. And
right
on down the road.
And so, but it goes on for another like 10 minutes. But I swear to God, the dude that did that with Matt Mardigan, I swear to God, just look it up, and it's genuinely worth a watch. Oh fuck! Gavel sound. I got all these vapes. God damn it. Like, and I know for a fact Rip saw that and he had to have laughed his ass off. had to. Oh my God. So, anywho, back to the most important part. We were talking about Christy. We were betting on Josh had a nice ass. I said, yes. Josh specifically said she has a boyfriend. That doesn't stop the fact on whether or not someone has a.
That doesn't mean anything. Honestly, I don't. I think my ass is probably like the least attractive thing about me.
I doubt.
I was really wondering where he was going with
that. To the ass. I'm an ass man. Josh, really, TJ, Stan, Abelette. We're all Josh. Even this Josh. Oh fuck! I feel like we just missed it. She ran out of the room. God damn it. can you tell him to come in? Well, what does he have a nice ass?
What?
He's like, don't worry about him.
Yeah, I said, does he have a nice ass? And you slam the door. I don't know what that means.
Oh, I accidentally left the door open and my boyfriend heard. He's like, bullshit.
See?
You ready for this? Would you rather?
Good. What?
You ready for this? Would you rather?
Do it.
Let's do it.
All right. So, old coworker of mine asked me this one. It was kind of strange, but I was like, all right. If you had to choose one for the rest of your life, would you rather sweat mustard or wear clothes made out of nothing but bacon?
That's an easy one.
Yeah, I thought so as well, kind of.
It's not. Bacon has a stronger scent, and I love bacon. But if it was, it's just like this. I love the smell of, like, but to lick some vaginas. But I want to smell that when I'm not horny. You know what I'm saying? So it's too much of a good thing. So who is doing that?
We'll change it real quick. Can you?
Gomer, fucking.
What's up?
What's going on, bro?
Hello.
So let's.
Can you eat the bacon?
But nobody's ever said you couldn't.
And I pick bacon.
I guess the other question is, do you get
if you have to wear that for the rest of your life, you always have bacon. But then you just eat bacon whenever you want.
Sex? I mean, who doesn't sweat during sex? And you get mustard all over?
But you can take your clothes off. You can take clothes off.
I just really don't like to sweat anyway, so if I'm going to start sweating mustard...
I think the best would you rather of all time is probably the one where it's like, if you had to choose, it's Freaky Friday and your wife and your girlfriend,
and your girlfriend's
Friday. Yeah.
No, I know what you're talking to. Do it. Say it.
Yeah, okay. So would you rather in a Freaky Friday situation where your mom switches bodies with your girlfriend, would you rather fuck your mom in your girlfriend's body or your girlfriend in your mom's body? But you have to pick one.
Jesus, fuck.
I feel like my mom would correct me the whole time.
Oh, that's some fucked up shit.
Like, I'm just saying,
you're not doing it right.
Yeah, exactly. Like, I would just, like, is this, how do you think Mandy would feel if we, I'm like, stop, mom? You know what I'm saying? Like, it'd just be fucked up.
No, for me, the choice is easy, though, because, I mean. Now, hold on. Would she have your mom's voice? Oh, man.
Shit.
I would say probably, yeah.
That would be fucked up. No, because if it's a body, it's got to be the,
you just switched bodies.
The oral cords.
Yeah, I'm gonna pick.
I just fucked up my
girlfriend's body because they make ball gags.
Oh shit!
Yeah.
And you have, you have to live with the rest of your life that you ball gagged your mom to fuck her. That's pretty
okay. So you, I'm sorry. Look, they're two pretty fucked up one options, but you're either fucking your mom.
This is body.
Or you just quiet your mom.
But see, if she had your girlfriend's voice, then you know you wouldn't really know the difference.
True. That, but then you'd be also have like this weird PTSD for the rest of your marriage of your wife correcting you.
Yeah,
what I think we just saw Chrissy's ass.
We did.
A little bit.
Yeah,
you turned around real quick.
Ow! I wanted to ask my boyfriend that question.
So there real you go. Quick. That's a good one for him. This is a stupid one.
Hey, there he is.
This is what they ask. Which in a Freaky Friday situation, if your mom switched places with your girlfriend, you know Freaky Friday, right? Yeah. You know Freaky Friday. So I'd be in your mom's body.
He gets in a lot of Freaky Fridays.
Me in your mom's body or your mom in my body? Oh. Isn't that really horrible?
You have to answer.
I'm taking a piss. Yeah, go for it. You have to be thinking about
it. I'm just thinking. Because his dick is in his hands. Well, which one stays hard longer?
Hey, turn the question for Christy.
Okay, Perler.
Yeah.
Where were you going with that? What's your answer?
I was going to say I'd have to go girlfriend in my mom's body because at least then there's a chance that my mom would never know anything about it. Yeah, but then you would be then fucking you would your
know
mom.
You know too much about your mom.
Yeah.
Well,
what if you found out she had herpes? You know what I mean? Like, that's some shit you'd never come back from. You know what I mean?
Well, hold on. Turn this question around for Christy. Yeah. Fuck her dad in her boyfriend's body or her boyfriend in her dad's body.
Oh,
there's
shit.
A good switch. Hashtag no sexism. She's like, no.
Don't turn your fucking mic on because we got to hear this.
Yep, turn your mic on.
Unmute it.
Do it.
We can't hear you, Christy. Come on. Still can't hear you. Turn the mic on.
I feel like we have some deaf people that could read your lips, though.
Yeah, De Niro hero.
We can't hear you. Please
turn your mic. No comprende hero.
Oh.
Okay.
It has to be my boyfriend's body.
Yeah, I agree.
See, it sounds weird when I pick the girlfriend's body, but.
No, I agree. Yeah.
Either way, you would rather that situation.
In that situation, you would still be your boyfriend's body. It'd just be your dad.
Well, yeah.
Okay.
Well, hey, let's take this back.
I just have to say, Dad, omit this from memory, please.
Anything that starts with dad,
have you ever called your boyfriend daddy?
It's terrible.
Well, because your dad's in your boyfriend's body, right?
Right, I get it. I'm just saying anything that starts with mom, comma, dad, comma, insert whatever, parent or guardian, comma, it's just fucking gross, man.
Under those pretenses, yes.
That's why the question's so
completely
hard.
Skip but the first one because that one was just stupid.
Christy, have you ever called your boyfriend daddy?
No.
So real quick, would you rather have Cheeto fingers for the rest of your life or have a popcorn kernel stuck in the back of your throat for the rest of your life?
Oh, Cheeto fingers.
Cheeto fingers.
Yeah,
because they're there for the rest of your life. You can just sit there all day.
Oh, fuck yeah.
No.
Even when you wash them, they'll still be like that.
It doesn't say you can't wear gloves.
No, still couldn't do it. Popcorn kernel.
What? No. Fuck no. Hell no. That shit hurts so bad.
Oh,
I gotta go Cheeto fingers.
It would, but I couldn't do the Cheetos on the fingers. Gloves or not, couldn't do it.
Why?
The best and hardest.
I have to eat with only two fingers. If I have anything on the rest of my fingers, it's immediately you have to wash them. I can't do that. Yeah.
Oh, here's a pretty good one. Would That's you rather weird. Look 10 years older from the neck up or from the neck down? That's a solid question.
10 years younger or older?
Older.
From the neck up.
From the neck up or the neck down.
But the thing is, your dick just never changed.
Yeah, I would say neck down because if you have any gray hair in your pubes, it'll make your balls look more distinguished.
Wait, say that again?
I would say from the neck down, because if you have, you're 10 years older and you have gray hair and your pubes will make your balls look more distinguished.
You know, I never understood why old guys.
I guess it also kind of depends on what your body looks like now, but it also depends to where you think it's going to be in 10 years.
Old guys always complain about their balls hanging lower. Like, isn't that what all guys want? Like, I want balls to hit my fucking feet when I walk. Am I the only one?
Yeah, but you don't want them sucking them down in the toilet.
Wait, do you think that's going to happen to you in 10 years?
They do testable weightlifting in China.
Would you rather have a Lamborghini or infinite knowledge?
Knowledge.
Infinite knowledge.
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 Knowledge. Knowledge.
Because if you have infinite knowledge, you can make enough money to buy a Lambo.
No, you can't. No, you can't. My favorite.
If you had infinite knowledge, you would know exactly where to go and get one without being caught stealing one.
But you will, because it's always.
But you have infinite knowledge.
You would also have the infinite knowledge of knowing you're about to get caught, because all Lambos have more LoJack sensors on their body panels and rims than they do in all of Chicago.
But hold on, if you have
infinite knowledge,
you would know that.
You can build your own business and make your money and do whatever the fuck you want.
So here's my favorite question in the whole wide world, and there is a right answer and a wrong answer. Would you rather be rich as fuck or famous?
Rich.
Yep.
Rich.
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 Because if you're famous, you can lose that money hella quickly with just
so. I got into almost a fist fight with somebody at a fucking dinner with Man. This is why Mandy doesn't bring me places. I was in a fist fight because he's like, "You're stupid. If you're famous, yeah, this is why." She's like, "He's like, if you're stupid, if you're famous, you can get rich off of being famous." I'm like, "Listen, you hoe."
Yeah, but then you MC can turn around and ask Robin Williams or something.
MC Hammer is also broke and famous.
He got rich again.
Even the people that are rich and famous, they have zero privacy. It's like, no.
Yeah. I'd rather be rich and
fuck buy my own rich Hammer and do whatever the fuck you want and build your own privacy.
I would rather be rich.
Not swarmed by, you know, everybody.
Buy fame. You can't buy rich. Being famous.
Isn't MC Hammer one of the many partial owners of the UFC now?
Yeah, no, but listen, you're not getting where I'm coming from. Okay.
It's money though.
Julia, okay. Here's one. Charles Manson is fucking broke and dead. And he's one of the most famous people on planet Earth. There you go.
I guess it depends on where you're famous.
I don't know. They never
look at Robin Williams.
Yep.
And I mean, fuck, there's, what's that dude from The Dark Knight?
Oh,
Heath Ledger. Yeah.
Famous,
but they're both dead.
And essentially.
So, like, even though you're famous, you're not really happy.
You tend to be more famous after your death.
Yeah. Mm,
but look at someone
in Tupac. In situation.
Yeah, in situation. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. So you look at, like,
well, what if you're famous and you're considered dead by a bunch of people because your career took a shit?
Here's a good example. House of Pain. Everlast. Everlast now is like upper middle class. When he was in House of Pain, he was famous and a shitty rapper and rich. Now he's not as famous, nowhere near as famous, but an amazing rapper and upper middle class. I would much rather have that balance any day of the week than famous, a shitty rapper, and rich. Or shitty anything and rich. I would, fuck, gross. Well, you want to
please? All right, you guys, I gotta go. It's that time of the day.
I see how it is.
Peace.
Well, you can look at it that way with Kid Rock. Kid Rock was a shitty rapper, and he's still famous, but he's still a shitty rapper.
Yeah.
I saw him in concert. He's a fucking amazing performer. Shitty fucking person.
Look at Kid Rock's first little bit when he was a rapper. He was on ICP's album.
Yep, I remember.
That was the shit. I'm sorry, but he's the first white guy I've heard to say the N-word.
I'm trying to think.
Wait, you mean like publicly and got away with it?
Yeah. He did it on their album.
Can we skip like prior 1950?
Well, I was just saying
Vanilla Ice.
There's a lot of ones that said the N-word.
Johnny Rebel,
the whole album.
Well, I'm saying like modern.
Johnny Rebel is racist. What the fuck? He says ninja with a hard R. You feel me?
Yeah. So does, well, no, Kid Rock says it with an A.
Hey, yeah.
Yeah, you but either way,
that's which the is first... more offensive, hard R or with an A?
No, definitely Johnny Rebel trying R. to be offensive. He's purposely being offensive. He's saying some fucked up shit. Real fucked up.
Well, who was that other guy? Is
hilarious.
Is, oh shit, I can't think of it without saying.
Who?
Oh, man.
Did you shave?
I can't even think of it. Yeah, the side and right here.
Don't be doing on the that side.
Bro. Not like Ken, but
I was gonna say Ken fucking
some,
went
some
ham.
Of us just grew up back.
Yeah, I seen that shit on Jay Hayes' channel.
I know. She was funny.
That was funny as fuck. He did definitely look like Captain Spaulding.
A little bit. I don't know who that is, but yeah.
You don't know who
Devil's really? Rejects, come on.
Devil's Rejects.
The oh my god, yeah. Oh, shit. I don't remember names like that. And a fucking
hold up, I'll be right back.
Okay. Who said that?
Gomer.
Who's Gomer going?
I don't know. He just said he'd be right
there. Are you guys
All right, guys. It's fucking midnight. I was going to go a half an hour ago.
The RDA.
Whoopsies. I love each and every one of y'all educators. Gomer's gonna be pissed. Crazy Wolf says Vanilla Ice. What about the guy? I met him. He's a fucking nice ass dude. He's a pretty firm handshake too. Surprise for someone who fucking grew up in Florida. I'm just saying.
Real quick, what is you have any updates on the e-liquid line?
Yes, that's what I was gonna ask you about 30 minutes ago, man.
Mm-hmm. All right, I'm back.
Welcome back.
Welcome back. Because we're about to go. I do. I can't. Can't talk about it right now.
Good.
Is one of the juice names going to be nasty?
It's going to be 32 below, asshole. if I do come up with a nasty one, it's going to be like a cheesecake mudslide or something weird.
Or name one. It sounds good. With Kahlua.
It sounds good, yeah. But then once you mix in the name, nasty.
Yeah. The picture is going to be like, you can't tell if it's a banana split or a doo-doo from a homeless person. It's going to be one of the other. It's going to look icky pooch. Back to showcase, mother truckers. Now, with that being said, I want to thank the whole panel for being here this evening. Thank you guys so much. Each and everybody, Avalanche, Andrew, a.k.a. Gomer Powell, Josh Cooper, motherfucker, TJ Morse, Stan, Perler. And then Joshua. Bet the showcase, mother truckers. Now, with that being said, I want to tell you that I appreciate you for Vaping with Thesis.
Peace. Have a good day.